welcome you back wherever you might be viewing the Hula Bowl, the North and the South from Honolulu and Aloha Stadium. The South won the toss and defer. The North will receive. And that is Andy Russ from Mississippi State that's got it teed up and set to kick away. And Archie Amerson and Bo Morgan. Bo to the left, Archie to the right, back deep, and the Hooters Hula Bowl is underway from Aloha Stadium. Amerson's going to have to take it 6 yards deep. Bo Morgan says, keep it right there, Arch. And the North will go to work offensively from its own 20-yard line. That brings out Steve Sarkisian, who we saw this year in a win over Utah. I said, Steve, we didn't get to see enough of you. And he said, yeah, the game that you did, we threw 12 passes. Kinder and Schuster joins him in the North backfield. Leshinsky, Kidd, and Manning. Kidd and Manning, the wideouts. Leshinsky from Army, the tight end. And up front, here's how the North offensive line looks. Cohn, Malapiai, Kempfert, Anafa, and Whitmore across the front wall for the North All-Stars. Sarkisian with the huge numbers at BYU. And microphone for our game. And an end around on the first play of the ball game. James Kidd of Colorado got the corner. Down the sideline is Kidd. And across midfield, all the way down to the 50, to the 49-yard line. That's the way to start things off, a 30-yard run.
Are you allowed to run reverses in this game?
I just did.
Apparently, the North has been working on their game plans real early. Everyone thought maybe, oh, this is just going to be runoff tackle, and all of a sudden, here comes the speed in this football game from Colorado. Kidd gets around the corner. I thought for a second he had the distance, but caught off very smartly with a good angle from Clarence Thompson.
So he came over to make the play just on the south side of the 50. One play, 31-yard game, and a first down. Now Schuster inside, big fella from Nebraska, and he goes for about 3 to the 46. Defensively for the South, Kenny Holmes, we talked about from Miami, had 11 sacks this year. Terry, Spain, and West across the front four. The linebackers, James Hamilton, big fella from North Carolina, Crawford, and Clint Bruce from Navy. And in the South secondary, Austin, Thompson, Fogle, Kenny Harris. Quick snap, Sarkisian, the out to Harris. And Marcus is very close to a first down as the Biletnikoff Award winner goes out at the 40-yard line. That's what he does well, get it out to him quickly.
Actually, that's what both Sarkisian and Harris do well, run timing routes, get the ball in and out of their hands. Marcus Harris might be limited a bit in this football game because he runs a lot of option routes at Wyoming where he's reading the coverage and finding the soft parts of it. In this game, he won't have the liberty to do that, but he's got a quarterback he's used to throwing the same thing, so, hey, improvise a bit.
That's right. There's the numbers for Marcus this year. Three times over 1,400 yards receiving. Third down at short. Sarkisian on the give inside and bouncing out is Kinder, and his second effort got him the first down as Terrell Peters of Oklahoma made the tackle, but Randy bounced it into the pile and then cut outside and picks up the first.
We have been listening to Steve Sarkisian call the snap count early in this football game, and if you follow football a little bit, this will be a chance to hear the cadences of some of these guys. You're even getting into the huddle occasionally.
Split right, skinny corner, I'm one on it.
Skinny post means that Bo Morgan and James Kidd will go down about 10 yards and try to get just inside the corner and before the safety can get there.
Kidd to the right, Morgan to the left, and Sarkisian's looking Bo's way and running out of time. Throws on the run and getting a hand out of Clint Bruce out of Navy. Knocks it away.
Clint Bruce out of Navy is one of the guys that we're going to have to keep an eye on throughout this whole football game. He's really kind of taken this game by storm. Kind of an interesting story. Wants to be a Navy SEAL. Yeah. I don't know why anyone would want to do that. But I guess middle linebackers are a good candidate for it.
That's right. He's used to this stadium. He had a huge game in the win by his team over Cal in the Aloha Bowl on this very field. Quick snap out of the gun. Kinder wide open in the flat, and a nice open field stop put on him by Peters out of Oklahoma, and a very short game. It's going to bring up third down and long. Tyrell, a 6-footer, 223 out of OU. Lou Holtz, head coach of the North, former coach at Notre Dame, obviously, said to him yesterday, so, Lou, what's in your future? You going to the pros? He lit his pipe and said, I'm just worrying about coaching the North tomorrow.
That's right. He gave the Bill Parcells answer, didn't
he? Yeah, he gave us a stiff arm on that one. Third down.
Check.
Sarkisian changes things up on a third and complete to his tight end.
Ball loose.
Yep. Let's see who's got it.
I think the South ball
might be Clarence Thompson down on the bottom of the pile. He's got part of that football anyway.
The ball was well thrown, but I think Anthony Fogle is the guy who made the hit on that. But it came from inside. That ball was there. It was a first down play. We will see. Watch the throw. Bruce almost gets it. Here comes Fogle up. That's the guy that causes the fumble. It rolls around. Leshinsky was the tight end that caught it from Army. Watch Fogle come up. The free safety. Ball pops out. Clarence Thompson ends up with the football.
So a couple of Oklahoma defenders come up big in that series. And now, offensively, Amory Smith takes it out. 10 yards, actually 11. He's got a first down on the first play of the game for the South. Danny Orfel, the Heisman Trophy winner. As Chris said, he'll play this first series, probably may not throw a pass, still suffering from the injury suffered in the national championship win. Thompson and Smith in the backfield with him. The wide receivers, Messum and Miller. And John Allred, the big tight end out of USC. And up front, Linen, Thomas, Casey, and Casey Jones, no relation. And Adam Meadows out of Georgia, the other tackle. There was a penalty on that last play. Negates a first down run by Emory Smith. They're going to back it up to about the 22-yard line.
Two of the best gamers in college football are Danny Werfel and Coy Detmer. If they say they're hurt, they're hurt.
They're hurt. That's right.
They can't play. It is legit. They're not doing any dodging.
First down. And the pitch. Look out.
A double pitch.
And out of bounds, and another big loss. Danielle Ferguson has to take it out of bounds.
Watch Danny Werfel in warm-ups today. He dropped about four or five snaps in warm-ups before the football game. I just don't think running plays at Danny Werfel match up too well.
He's not used to that.
No. Ball landed on the line, turns around, tries to get rid of him. He was tackled just as he let the ball go by Myron Elzey.
Well, Danny wants to stay healthy. Having Elzey draped all over him is not going to help the cause too much. Took a pretty good shot. It's way back now at the 12-yard line. Second down, 26. Little draw play, quick opener, David Thompson. And the Oklahoma State running back takes it out across the 15-yard line. Run out by Van Washington. As we look at the defense of the North, Bill Ennis-Inge out of Iowa, Gary talked about in the open, Curry, Elzey, who made a nice play a moment ago, and Matt Finkus, who was the defensive MVP of the East-West Shrine game. Hemsley, Inkaliaga from right here in Honolulu, and Kenan Tatum, the linebackers. Joe Gordon, Van Washington, who made that last play. Steve Rosga of Colorado, and Kim Herring of Penn State, a couple of very, very talented safeties. Third down, a mile for Werfel. And this just shows you that they're not going to use his arm.
How about that combination? Bobby Bowden and Danny Werfel on third and long running the ball up the middle.
What Coach Bowden couldn't do earlier this season, take Werfel out of the game, he's going to probably have to now. Isn't that
right? That's right. Well, I think, and we're going to probably talk to Danny before this, but before he gets too far along in this football game, but he heard that game and probably played the whole second half of that game against Florida State with a bruised arm, and still showed up, still practiced, was all the meetings and everything like that, and got out there and got the first snaps underway.
Rush to punt, high, lazy kick. Kim Herring, a little double clutch there, but he handles it with a fair catch right about at the 42-yard line. With 12 minutes and 14 seconds remaining in the first quarter from Honolulu, no score between the North and the South. We've got a penalty marker down where he caught that ball.
I don't think
they gave him enough room, did
they?
No,
they didn't. I think Clint Bruce was like within Navy Sea. He could have took and went out one of those Bowie knives out and done anything he wanted to do right there.
Yeah, he's got the knife right down by his hip pad there someplace right there. Look
there
out.
He goes
get
by.
Out of the way. Danny Werfel, the Heisman Trophy winner, maybe done for the day. No score here early. Of the Midwest that have been ravaged, we almost have to apologize that we're here.
Yeah, we're probably going to stay an extra couple days, just to do some post-work.
Sarkisian, the toss to Amerson, and R.G. Amerson back into South Territory at the 48-yard line. Here's a guy that the Peyton Award winner, over 2,000 yards on the ground this season, and not the biggest fella in the world, but when we talked to Lou Holtz yesterday, he said he's got a pretty good chance, does everything very well.
Yeah, I think that's the case. He's could show that he's going to be able to return punts, catch the ball a little bit. Coach Holtz told us the one thing he's going to have to do is become more detail conscious if he wants to play with his size at the next level. He can still Steve is still telling him what to do right now.
That's right. Play action by Sarkisian out of the shotgun. Scrambling around on second and four, and he's going to get what he can. Whoa, look out. Get that yard marker out of the way over there.
That's what Sarkisian does so well, is never really loses his wits about him as where he is on the football field, doesn't waste any energy, and like most BYU quarterbacks, keeps his eyes downfield as he scrambles around. He just made a very confined move there and made a play that was nothing, turned it into a decent play.
Go now. Go. Go. Split right, quick slant, on set, ready? On set.
All right, well, you got a pass coming up on second down, third down, and a long three.
He's got his own receiver, Kaipo McGuire, at the bottom of the screen.
Looking at Kaipo the whole way, a little bit high on the delivery. Kaipo says, hey, how about a flag? No call.
I think he got hit that time by Doe Henderson, the Hawaii corner, just before the ball got there.
No marker, and that'll bring up a punting situation.
I don't know if the ball was catchable, though, to tell you the truth.
Looked a little too high for me.
Kaipo's going to come to his right, our left here, and watch him get bumped. Yeah, see, that's what everybody's going to talk about on those type of plays. Kaipo says, hey, I could have had it. I got a 38-inch vertical.
That's right.
I'd have laid out.
Rialli out of Syracuse to punt. On fourth down, Dedrick Ward and Khalif Muhammad are back as dual safeties. Good-looking kick. Got a chance to cover this one. And almost. Nice hustle downfield. Unable to save it, though. Rialli almost got himself a coffin corner kick. For a wrap-up of everything going on in sports today and every day, be sure to check out ESPN News. First ever 24-hour sports news network brings you all the scores, the highlights, up-to-the-minute reports, and comprehensive analysis anytime you want it. Call your local cable operator or satellite provider to make sure you get hooked up with ESPN News. And you can catch a sneak peek of ESPN News at halftime of our game. Brad Otten, quarterback for USC, the big guy, 6'6", and back to throw on first down. Complete out to his wide receiver, Chris Miller. So the battery that the Trojans had so much success with this year picks up decent yardage on the first pass play of the ball game. And there's Brad Otten's numbers.
What you got, big man?
For John Robinson.
That's what I tell you, a lot of players like that when you're calm and confident in the huddle. What do you got there, big man?
Here we go. 5'5", 31 quick, 101, right?
31 quick means a fullback. Smith's going to get it. Keep your eye on the upback.
There's Emery. Emmett's little brother, if you will. All, what, about 245 pounds of him. He says, you know, if you're always going to be in somebody's shadow, my brother's not a bad shadow to be in.
That's for sure.
He's a good fullback down at Clemson. Put up bigger numbers last year than this year, quite frankly. Kind of played with some injuries that hampered his play, shoulder and back problems this year.
And I think with the emergence of, big fullbacks in the league and what they're going to be able to do, that they've got to keep a guy on a fullback.
Otten on second down, stands tall and rifles it to Miller. And a first down out at the 45-yard line. Chris Miller, whose cousin Keshawn Johnson, they played together right on through high school.
All the way down the field.
Keshawn on to the number one draft choice of the Jets.
And the thing that you like about Brad Otten, if you watch all the quarterbacks in this game, he definitely has the strongest arm, but as tall as he is, he still looks like he's athletic. And that's hard to do when you start to get bigger and bigger. You become, at least to the naked eye, a little bit stiff. He looks very athletic in his drop and does a good job releasing the ball.
Almost 5 minutes into the first quarter, no score. Smith again, the fullback, straight up the middle. Got about three. Tatum, the linebacker out of Notre Dame, is the first to meet him. Danny Werfel on the sideline, probably done for the day.
He's the disaster quarterback now.
That's right. Chris Fowler will be talking to him later on.
I think the challenge you have for this North football team is they really only have four defensive backs on the team, two corners and two safeties. They're going to have to go the whole way. And luckily for them, it's a little bit overcast today.
That's right. Almost threw the North offside. And then the counter gets really nothing. Maybe a yard for James Allen out of Oklahoma. And Matt Rice out of Northwestern and on the tackle.
Well, there's one of those guys, Matt Rice, and that just watching Big Ten football, everybody says he doesn't have the right size body, he doesn't have the right feet, so he just keeps making tackles.
Yep. Double curl, one-on-one, right?
As Matt his numbers this year, he was co-defensive MVP on the Northwestern squad along with his buddy and little linebacker Pat Fitzgerald. Otten to throw. Boy, he rifles that. He knows where Chris Miller is on the field, I'll tell you that much.
You heard him after the last pass he completed to Miller. He said, we could do that all the way down the field. He's just throwing it right off the linebacker on those plays, and he just feels confident. Zone defense. And you know, when you're a smart quarterback, will go to his own guy, the guy he feels comfortable with. That's his teammate right there. Might as well throw it. He's going to throw it right off the shoulder of that linebacker right there. Boom, it's in the hole, and that's all curl. That's kind of like the passing 101.
And they 101 it down to the 37-yard line. First down, a little draw play and some miscommunication on which way that was coming from, and Emery Smith still makes it good for five. Quarterback.
What in the heck was that play?
Oh, people only knew what was going on in the field and all the talking, huh?
All it takes is to turn the wrong direction. You almost get run over by your fullback.
ISO 101, right?
Well, this is going to be really a run to the left side, ISO. That means he's going to, tailback is going to follow Smith. That's not a bad play.
Watch double Deuce. Deuce Staley out of South Carolina. And Deuce has got it down to the 30. Matt Finkus helps out on the tackle. Deuce Staley, all SEC first team tailback. There's the numbers he put up this year for the Gamecocks.
And when you average 124 yards a game in the SEC, especially, you know, that everyone knows it in South Carolina, do a lot of passing nowadays. You have the ability to play, and there's just a lot of backs on this South team. They're not going to get a lot of carries.
Trying to spread it out to everybody.
Sean Mitchell's in right now.
Sean out of Texas, tailback right now. He gets in on a toss. And reads his blockers and cuts up nicely. He's got a first down. Mitchell out of the 25-yard line. He had a huge season last year. And again, due to injuries, his number's off a little bit this season. But we've seen him before. And that two-headed tailback, two-headed backfield they had in Texas, John Makovic, was something special. This guy's a good one.
Of course, Texas ended up being one of the most powerful offenses in the country, right? At the end of the year last year.
First down at the 25-yard line. Miller and Ward, wide outs for Otten. Looks back to his teammate, throws a quick out inside the 20. Down to the 19-yard line. That's what, four catches for Chris Miller?
Yeah, it appears a bit easy, doesn't it, right now? You just bring your own receiver out here. You know the team is playing either man-to-man coverage or a very simple zone, nothing complicated, so.
It's like bringing your own clubs out here to
golf. That's right. You know, you rent clubs to golf, and you really don't do as well, believe me.
Well, your numbers look pretty good the other day.
Got to hurry now. 4-I, 29 sweep, reverse at 9, one-on-one.
Oh,
right?
Both teams
at
put
eight,
a reverse
at eight.
At 8.
At 8. At 8.
On a second down.
One.
And a long four. There's the toss to Mitchell, and the end around coming the other way. And it goes backward about 5 or 6 yards.
Yeah, Matt Finkus is not going to be fooled. 3-year start at Ohio State. He was all Big Ten as a sophomore, all Big Ten again as a senior. He read that play, or he heard the play.
Yeah, one of the two.
Because he was yelling at 8, at 8, at 8. Finkus is no dummy out there. Comes back. But if he hadn't made the tackle, number 15, Steve Rosga, had read it, he'd have been there also.
Matt and Mike Vrabel, a combination at Ohio State that played so many games together and had so many tackles for loss and sacks together over their careers. As we approach 6 minutes, first quarter, no score, and a third down and 11 to Brad Otten. Got some pressure from behind. Throws it. Wow.
Thrown a little late, but Joe Gordon did a nice job of handling the ball. That was the first duck, really, that Otten had thrown.
Can you get my ball in there?
How did you hear that right now?
Can you guys get my ball in there?
There has been a little bit of talk about this football game. The Hula Bowl has made a contract with Rawlings, a new football. Now, the football's fine, but it's not the football Brad Otten has thrown all year, and you could hear him say, as he threw his first knuckler,
can't you
I didn't get
my
ball.
So that'll bring up fourth down and 11. Neither of these teams is that confident with their kicking game, because for the most part, both these guys are punters by trade, not kickers. And so here comes Andy Russ right now to try about a 43-yard field goal. Yeah, they got a lot of leg into it, and he got it. Well, forget what I said, Andy. Sorry. 43-yard field goal breaks our scoreless tie. And on the board, the South, they lead by three. Joe Gordon played that pass by Otten at the goal line extremely well. Broke it up, forced a field goal.
Nice and good out here. This is my boy, Ross. We're going to crack tight.
Bobby Bowden enjoying himself, as he always does. Head coach at Florida State. South with a lead and a kick, and Bo Morgan will field this one 5 yards deep. Bo says, I'm coming out.
That time the blockers in front were not moving fast enough for Bo, and he kind of got slowed up by his home wedge blockers.
Bo got back out close to the 19-yard line, and that's where the offense will work. Bo will play a little bit of everything today. Maybe some quarterback, some running back. He could play safety. And we've seen him do a number of things.
Now watch Bo. He's ready to go. 4-4 here and 4-5 speed, and the wedge is moving at 5-flat. That doesn't work. Get out of the way, boys.
Got to do some matriculating down the field. There's Morgan's numbers. Running back this year.
Ready.
Sarkisian going to Morgan. And he makes the catch across the 30, first down.
Option route by Bo Morgan that time. He came out, read the linebackers in zone, and just turned around and said, give me the ball. Morgan coming out. He's going to see the two linebackers to his right and his left. He said, this is a soft spot, just like Coach said. Now, just don't back up, Bo. That's not a shotgun snap. You got to come and get it.
Bo, the first player in NCAA history to rush and pass for 1,000 yards in two seasons. Put up phenomenal numbers, as you already saw his rushing totals. He's not a bad passer either.
No, and they do have the halfback pass in. Let me just predict that.
Bo's a tailback in the eye right now. The first down from the 31. There's the toss.
Here it is. Here right here.
Wants to throw back to Sarkisian, who's wide open. Penalty marker down as Sarkisian goes across the 40 for another first down.
What I think they did is had linemen downfield that time is what I think they were going to call on it.
Always seems to be a BYU quarterback sneaking out to get an option pass back, right?
Jim McManning got good athletes there.
Mm-hmm. Frank White's our referee. He's going to straighten it out for us.
Yep, one of those dang blockers downfield.
Oh, boy.
They worked on that play every day.
Coach Holt says, unbelievable. Good-looking play, but it comes back. And now that one's wasted for the rest of the game.
Yeah, that's right. That's like firing one of your Tomahawk missiles. You only have one of them, right?
That's it.
Right or left? You probably said left and you're running away. Boom, boom.
Let's listen in.
Let's go. On set now, on set. Right, toss, sweep, right. On set. Ready?
Little discrepancy on whether or not Coach Holt said left or right on the toss sweep. So let's see if everybody goes the right direction. Amerson cuts outside and got the corner. Oh, man, did he get bulldozed when he got out there by Ray Austin.
He got a mouthful also.
Oh.
Of course, Ray Austin is playing corner in this game and played corner for Tennessee this year, but also played 2 years as a strong safety for Tennessee. And when you play strong safety in the SEC Conference, you're known and have the ability to come up and take out a running back, especially one that's 5'6".
Ray had maybe his best game of the year against Alabama. 10 tackles and an interception. There's his numbers on the season, including 4 picks. That one was a head-on collision. No gain.
Set! Ready!
On 2nd and 10. Pump fake by Sarkisian. Wants it all. Long ball downfield. Just overshot. Kaipo McGuire, his teammate from BYU. Kaipo, one of the local favorites here because of having grown up in the area. Let's check in with Chris.
Well, Brad, you got the guy who put the South on top, 3-0, Andy Russ with the field goal. When was the last field goal you kicked before that 43-yarder?
The last time I kicked a field goal was high school, my senior season.
You've been a punter at Mississippi State. What happened when you tried that for the Bulldogs kicking chores?
I believe it was my freshman year. I hit a low one, hit the center right in the butt, so I didn't kick too often after that.
He's going to cast his lot in the NFL as a punter, perhaps. Guys?
All right. That's a great one. We were talking about that the other day, and that's why I said they were a little nervous about their kicking game. But he didn't look nervous on that 42-yarder. Down the middle, in and out of the hands of Brian Manning of Stanford, and he paid the price for dropping that ball. Lewis Adams out of Oklahoma State let him have it.
One of the real touch passes and one of the passes that everyone is throwing in college football right now is a wide receiver coming underneath the coverage, and that's exactly what Manning was attempting to do right there. I think San Francisco might have started that pass coming across the middle, but you have to be able to throw that ball sharply but not hard, and that time Sarkisian threw it too hard for Manning to catch the football.
Reale set to punt.
You understand that, sharply and hard?
Oh, absolutely. There's a difference. Ward and Muhammad are back waiting on the kick, and it's a nice one. Camped under it. Ward. And Ward brings it near side. Almost got around containment. It was Kiefer McGuire on the special teams, though, that collared him and drags him out of bounds at the 39-yard line. 4:27 remaining, first quarter. South leads the North in the Hooters Hula Bowl. 4:27 left, first quarter on that Andy Rush field goal. 3-0 the South. And they've got the ball back at their own 39-yard line. And a new quarterback in, Jim Arianas. Out of Fresno State will take over. Another big quarterback, 6'4". Here's a counter. Deuce Staley. And Deuce across the 45 to the 46. Ink Aliaga in on the tackle.
Ink. Of course, we just saw them in the Holiday Bowl. And Ink, a hole. Washington defense started out strong, ran out of gas a bit.
You know, we were talking about Ink's family just liked the name Ink. There's no particular reason for it. But his sister's names are Queen and Queena, and his brothers are named Vic and Ing. Now, you get all that together, and you got Ink and Vic and Ing, and I mean, you can get confused. That's in the right. Aliaga household, is what I'm saying. Second down and 4. Dancing around in the backfield is Danielle Ferguson. And he's going to be short of the first down by about a yard. Bellisari in on the stop.
All right, Matt Rice also on the bottom of that tackle. Did a good job again of playing off that block and standing up strong. And kind of ironic, but both Arianas and Otten were both rotating as quarterbacks a year ago in 1995. Neither one was the featured starter. Both emerged at the end of 95 and became the starters, and are both in the Hula Bowl. Played pretty good game in the Blues Bay Classic just a few weeks ago, too. Also.
That's right. Inside handoff looks like a first down, if you can tell through all the bodies flying around of the pile at about the 49-yard line. Gonna have to unpile and see where they spot this one. Lou Holtz, of course, his name is still speculated as a possibility as an NFL head coach. His name's been mentioned in New Orleans. There was so much fervor earlier about whether or not he'd end up with the Minnesota Vikings. And,
well, one thing that I thought was evident watching him on the practice field, that he feels at home being a football coach. Mm-hmm. If there's anything that a man was born to do would be a coach football, it might be Lou Holtz. I mean, he fished to a water when he got back out there telling guys what to do, where to line up, and how to do things.
That's right. Play action. Arianas going deep. And intercepted. Picked off by Kim Herring.
Yes, who?
He did that quite often for Joe Paterno, not only this year, but through his brilliant career.
Kim Herring was inside all the way that time and just baited that throw, and he knew he had Messam covered like a blanket, and then he bumped him right at the end. But Herring had a run of plays. He's going to be top left of your screen. You don't even see him yet. He'll come into the picture throwing the ball over the top, but there's the guy right there, and there's the football, and that's going to spell out interception every time when you throw it that late.
Herring at 7 for Penn State this year.
You know, more amazing than that was the way he ended up his season for Penn State. Talk about a 3-game stretch against Northwestern, Michigan, and Michigan State. He's personally responsible for 8 turnovers. Quite a 3-game stretch.
Kinder out of Notre Dame on the counter, and Randy takes it out close to the 15-yard line.
Kim Herring started as a tailback at Penn State. Renowned high school running back, moved his corner, played free safety for this football team this year, and I think he's going to be a tremendous professional football player because he just has a nose for the football and can play a number of different positions. And as we said, in those three games, he had 5 interceptions, a forced fumble, a tip pass for an interception, 22 tackles, and he broke up 8 passes. That's a scholarship right there.
It is. Second down at 4. Sarkisian on the give to Akili King. And Akili is going the other direction.
Akili
Stop
King.
For no game.
Akili King that time did not follow his blocking. He should have followed Kinder to the outside. It was a sweep. But if he'd have followed his halfback to the outside right here, you would have seen, watch Kinder come around, and the running back should have came right around him. Follow your back. Truck and trailer. Follow the truck, the trailer. Oh, no, that's jackknife right
yep.
there.
Part of those 18 wheels came off in a hurry.
Oh, boy.
Out on one, on one, ready?
Third down and about 5. Sound like we're going to have a quick out. Maybe to Guyful McGuire down at the bottom of your screen. Sarkisian is going to go the other way. Have to scramble for it. And nearly picked off. Nice play on the ball on the far side. Over there by Anthony Fogle. Let's check in with Chris.
We got Penn State safety Kim Herring made the interception. He's playing corner today. How do you like playing corner? It's a new position for you. Can you cover the NFL guys?
you know, everybody, well, I'll try, you know, but corner, I've played it before. Maybe not my college career, I played in high school. So, I mean, you know, I got to knock off a little bit of the rust, but I think I can do pretty well there.
Gary said he predicts a big NFL future for you. What quick can you bring to an NFL team?
I can probably bring the Penn State mentality of toughness and a lot more speed than people think, you know, safeties that I can have. And I can also, like I'm trying to show today, I can also cover man-to-man.
Showing some versatility. Good job.
No
guys.
Doubt about that. Another nice punt. Khalif Muhammad fields this one at the 36. And Muhammad gets it back across the 46. About an 11-yard return. Good field position again for the South after a 50-yard punt.
He also returned, speaking of Kim Herring, returned punts for Penn State. So just a guy who's comfortable with the football, especially when the ball's in the air as a DB, that's valuable.
Coming up on Monday, Big Monday, presented by Bud Light. Tim Thomas and Villanova, 16th-ranked Wildcats go against Syracuse. Then Oklahoma State will head to Lubbock, Texas, and they'll take on Tony Batty and the Texas Tech Red Raiders. After those two games, from the Big East and the Big 12, it's off to the Big West, Fresno State and UNLV. Tark back in Vegas at midnight. That should be interesting. That's our triple-header Monday.
So does basketball start pretty soon now that football's over? Or?
I guess you haven't seen the 15 games I've done already, huh? Brad Otten, USC, quarterback, back
in
there.
We got to get that ball in there?
Still trying to get
through
his own football in there.
90 out, one-on-one.
See, right? Now there's a key right there. Every time Otten gets his ball in, I'd look for a pass.
Well, he's only missed once, and that was that one that Gordon broke up. He's 4 out of 5 for 43 yards. All of them to his teammate. This time he overshot
Come on, get the
Dedrick
ball
Ward.
Out of there.
He doesn't like that football.
That's that ball.
Now, see, quarterbacks get used to a football. Doesn't mean that any ball is worse than the other. It's just that you get used to one, and it's really tough to come in here, especially when you know all the pro scouts are watching you.
You know, I don't know.
And you
are.
Say, hey, I only got a week to get ready here, and you got to change your game.
Through a 5L, 70 Y-ops, one-on-one, right?
Uh-oh, he
just said.
Head now.
He just said to Frank White, I can't throw that ball, and Frank White, the referee, said, I don't know where they are.
I think Lou Holtz has already got rid of them.
I think he has. They're hidden somewhere in a garage in downtown Honolulu. But he goes down the middle to his tight end, Fred Jones.
Whoa!
Jones is rumbling. Touchdown!
That guy's a tight end.
That was worth a rolling.
Well, there's a good commercial.
I'll take those.
He didn't throw a pretty one, but he threw to the right guy.
You got that right. Once Fred Jones got it, he didn't care what company made it.
Woo.
He was heading that way. 53-yard touchdown.
That guy can run.
That guy can run, he said, I guess.
Thanks, man.
And he is a big one, 6'5", 255.
And he's running away from some players that can run, too. Roska and Herring and all those guys were chasing him down that time. You got a 255-pound tight end who can catch and run like that. He's already made himself some money.
Ooh. Andy Russ in for the point after. Muhammad to hold for the left-footed kicker out of Mississippi State. Got it down. You can't rush the kicker in this game. That helps the cause a little bit when you're nervous about your kicking game. Something that's good. Otten hooks up long with a big guy from Chapel Hill. And with 43 seconds left in the quarter, here's that last touchdown.
Two-time All-ACC tight end from North Carolina. Can do more than block. He's a good football blocker at the tight end spot. Look, wide open this time in the zone. Maybe that should be a first down for most tight ends, but this time he runs past Mike Logan, who tries to go for the ball. Then Rosca just can't get close enough. Herring, a last-second try for it. Rosca, watch the straight arm here. This gives a John Mackey-type straight arm right there. Gets into the end zone and says, wow. This was, besides the beach and the sun, I get the score.
Rosca looked like he was trying to catch the bus, but he couldn't find a handle on the door.
Got to jump on then.
Well, that's the most impressive play of the day by far so far. And it's 10-0. The South leads the North. 43 seconds left, first quarter from Aloha Stadium in Honolulu. Brad Nessler, Gary Danielson, Chris Fowler, and our ESPN crew out here. Enjoying the warm weather and the hospitality of the folks in Honolulu.
Hey, watching the kids all week, they really did have a good time out here. I mean, I remember my first trip to Hawaii. It was like, wow, you know, and these guys get to come out here and have a great week, meet a lot of friends and pretty good football players, and try to make a help their own career out. They had two of the probably the best named coaches in college football involved in this game.
That's right. Russ's kick goes over to Brian Manning at the 5-yard line. Manning looking for his blockers and got it out to about the 20, and then got tagged by Terrell Peters, who's been involved in a lot of plays already out of Oklahoma. Let's check in with Chris Fowler. Chris.
I'm with a touchdown score. Freddie Jones, big guy, showing speed, running away from those little DBs in that play.
Well, you know, we worked on that play all practice. You know, I saw the opportunity, and I just jumped on.
They say it's a strong draft for tight ends. What can you bring that scouts will be looking for that maybe other guys don't have?
Well, I haven't looked at everyone else. All I can say is I'm going to work hard every play.
Off to a good start.
Thank you.
Mac Brown's All-ACC tight end.
Set! Ready, hit!
Sarkisian on first down. Plenty of time for Steve, and down the middle of McGuire. The first down toss, pickup of about 15 after his buddy. Kaipo holds on.
If there is a signature for BYU passing game, it is the deep crossing route. And you saw Sarkisian say, I can do it if the O-line can do it. And he says, nice job, O-line. Kept those guys off him, and there's some good pass rushers for this South team. Kenny Holmes out there, and Bantune, Joe Salavea, and they can rush the passer, so he had time to throw the deep route.
First down to the 37-yard line. And he's going to move his backs around, shoot to Amerson. And wants to flare it out. That might be a lateral to Amerson. Let's see what he does with it. Got back to the line of scrimmage. That's about it. Nice open field stop over there. James Hamilton and Clarence Thompson track down the little running back as the quarter comes to a close. We played 15 in the Hooters Hula Bowl, and the South leads the North by 10.
Look at the Archie Amerson this time.
Amerson in there on the right side of that dual backfield. And there's the throw, and he overshot him. And Amerson paid the price from Vernon Crawford out of Florida State. Vernon said, I'll hit you again if you come back.
Vernon Crawford, one of the fastest linebackers at Florida State. He's about 4'7", 4'8", linebacker, and has the size to match. So he's the one that the scouts will want to see in space. You know, he's probably done a lot of blitzing. Can he cover man-to-man? The rules in this game are you got to play man-to-man coverage, or you can drop in two different zones. There's only very simplified reads.
Second down and 10 from the gun. And Sarkisian scrambling around, and that is a loose football. And out of bounds it goes.
Kenny Holmes hit it so hard that time he knocked it out of bounds.
You got to hit him a little softer so the ball stays on the field of play.
That's a veteran type thing. But coming around the corner, one of the best pass rushers in college football, Kenny Holmes, matched up with a guy who doesn't do a tremendous amount of players with that type of speed matched up against him. Dennis Whitmore, I think, was on the outside to tackle from Las Vegas. He said, I've never seen anybody like this.
Kenny had 11 sacks this year and 30 in his career for Miami.
Did that Lawrence Taylor move, too, coming from the backside and swatting that thing. That's a signature Lawrence Taylor. LT.
Rialli to punt. He's punted well. Averaging 48. We've already had about that many plays in this game. It was 43 plays in the first quarter. Kick camped under it is Dedrick Ward. Ward from the 19, heading the other way. And got a nice block. Wow. Somebody just got ear hold out there. I think it was McGuire.
He doesn't even know if he's in his home state. Kenny Harris got the block, too, that time.
Kaipo's a local product here. He doesn't even know if he's home.
Well, remember Kaipo's last game in college, in the Cotton Bowl, he got a grade 2 concussion. He says, hey, how come I'm finding all these elbows lately? Kenny Harris is going to be on the left side of your screen. Watch number 16 in orange go backwards.
Oh. And Kaipo, look out.
Got Flippo.
Yep.
Got KO'd.
Well, Kenny's got a smile on his face. Kaipo might have two and not even realize it. First down at the 48. Throw out and caught a couple of times by Wayne Messam. Arianis throws it out. The big wide receiver out of Florida State makes the catch. I think you see there between Ennis and Messam, some of the most fun you have out here is what you do away from the football field. They practice together as teams, but then they go hang out together and go on boat rides and everything else.
That's
and have
right.
a great time.
They're separated for about an hour and a half practice, and then the rest of the time they're all hanging and doing everything together. And now the game, to put the pads on, they get to hit each other. And what a better thing to do than hit your buddy.
Yeah, that's right.
You're going to get beat by anybody. You don't want it to be your best buddy.
Lifelong friendships made in these kind of games. Here's a throw out. Ferguson broke one tackle, and he's got it to a first down at the 41. Danielle out of Miami. Scrambles around, picks up the first down.
I think that's one of the guys that I'm most interested in seeing in this football game. Danielle Ferguson had a great career running the ball, but he has to show he can catch the ball and do the other things that a running back can do.
Dislocated his hip against West Virginia, and that curtailed his season quite a bit, but he had a 1,000-yard junior campaign and just made a nice move there to pick up a first down at the 41-yard line. Deuce Staley, second man through. Down to the 39, got a couple. Deuce had a game against Kentucky that was one to remember this year, had over 190 yards and had almost that much against Georgia. Those were his two biggest games. At the 38-yard line, second down, rather, and about eight. Sean Mitchell comes back into the backfield behind Emory Smith. Jim Arianis out of Fresno State, 6'4", 210. On the give, Sean Mitchell, and Mitchell bounces back to the right side, waits for his blockers, and almost to the 20, and a nice open field stop by Joe Gordon, or Sean, is gone.
Boy, they ran that play right into the teeth of the defense that time. The rotation from the secondary had it right to them. You'll see the safety come right up to the outside, and that play should not have worked. But remember, this North secondary, no substitutes. You begin to tire as many plays as they've had. And you're right, Joe Gordon made the touchdown saving play because he had Wayne Messam right in his face, and he just fought off the block long enough to save a touchdown.
Sean Mitchell and Ricky Williams, that backfield in Texas that was so explosive. He's got it first down. Looks like an offside here, but Arianis might have a free play and lost one out. Incomplete. Herring was out there covering on Muhammad. I thought the defensive end for the North was offside.
Well, there's a flag down, so that may be the call.
Offside, North, and they will walk it off. It'll be first down at 5. Let's check in with Chris.
And with Steve Sarkisian, had a chance to catch the first pass of your college career, wiped out by an ineligible man downfield penalty.
Can you believe that, man? My first catch of my life, and it doesn't even count. Hello.
You got this game and then the combine, but scouts say you're not the kind of quarterback who's going to shine in workouts. You're more of a game guy. What can you do to show them that you can play in the next level?
I think a lot of it is just showing my arm strength, my decision making, and hopefully my leadership qualities. I think those things have helped me through my career, and hopefully they can continue to help me try to get to that next level.
This is the last game ever. Does that be okay with you?
I don't think so. I'm too much of a competitor.
You don't want to go out here.
I'm too much of a competitor. This is my last game.
Good luck, Steve. Yes.
Competitor he is. And we saw his very first game. Remember,
that's
Garrett, as BYU quarterback, threw a couple touchdown passes in that game. And, you know, he talked about the pressure of having to fill the shoes of the guys that came before him as the quarterback there.
Yeah, he filled in for Ty Detmer's shoes. Those are tough shoes to come in for. No, I'm fair. Sorry. There was one in
John
between.
Walsh.
John Walsh.
Right.
They all play in the NFL. You just grab a name.
Yeah, but just grab any BYU guy.
I think that when you look at a BYU quarterback, you always look at a good decision maker. And that's what I think Steve Sarkisian is, a good decision maker at quarterback.
First down at the 10-yard line. Arianna's pump. Ooh, that was a pump fake and a half. Now he throws on the run. Touchdown.
Yeah.
Got it. To Wayne Messam for the score, 10 yards.
Can't hold up that long in the secondary when you're out there one-on-one like that situation. That was more than a pump. I think he actually was going to throw that ball, but nobody at the last second was open, so he said, hey, let's pull it back, almost like a check swing in baseball. I know he went across the plate. Oh, yeah, he went across the plate right there.
And
now
then there was a strike right
you
here.
Bet. Came back, and Kim Herring just could not stay with Messam long enough to the outside in that play because that is just too long and man-to-man coverage. Nice play.
Nice solid throw going the other way. 10-yard touchdown, Arianna's to Messam. And Andy Russ, a busy kicker with a field goal and an extra point already. Normally a punter by trade at Mississippi State. Set for his second extra point attempt. Again, you won't see anybody rush the kickers. They just sort of stand up, and he knocks it through there. Wayne Messam for the Seminoles. Arianna's with the touchdown pass, and it's 17-0 South. The South leads the North 17-0 in the Hooters Hula Bowl. And the last touchdown, courtesy of Wayne Messam from Jim Arianna's 10-yard touchdown toss. And Andy Russ will kick. James Kidd and Brian Manning waiting on it for the North. This one might go out of bounds and does. Penalty marker. So we'll get that one up at the 35. Coming up your way on January 30th on ESPN and ESPN2, opening day of the inaugural Winter X Games. He's snowboarding in the half pipe, super modified shovel racing, snow mountain biking, ice climbing, you name it. Anything that's on snow will have it. The Winter X Games, 4 days of world-class competition from Big Bear Mountain in Snow Summit, California on ESPN and ESPN2.
Who do you like in that summer modified shovel racing?
I got a couple favorites. I got a guy in Wisconsin that I think's got a decent shot at that thing. 17-0, and Bo Morgan's going to take over at quarterback. Now we should see some sparks start to fly a little bit because he can do a lot of things well. Kinder, a little quick opener, and he's got about 9 out to the 44-yard line.
I think Randy Kinder is another one of those guys that's got looking at this football game as an opportunity to take a career that could have been and maybe give him one more game of life before he gives into the National Football League. One of the most highly recruited players out of Michigan ever, came right out of East Lansing, went to Notre Dame, and his career has been plagued by injuries. And this year, the most carries he had in any football game was 11 carries. That's tough for a tailback.
Whoa, that's tough on a tailback. That's Kenny Holmes again. That's the second big play he's made.
And that's when you go back to the offensive line in this football game, that might be the matchup that is the toughest for this North team. They lost Chris Nioli, their All-American player, and they're down to not as many talented players as the guy they're trying to block.
And he's a very talented player they're trying to block, number 90.
Right now, Scott Rayburg is trying to match up Kenny Holmes. Scott Rayburg played at Central Michigan. He has not seen a Kenny Holmes. You'll get used to him after a while. He's got the size and the talent, but in one game, it's tough to adjust.
And there's Rayburg, and he is huge. He's down to 320, and he's about 6'8".
He is something, and there is no fat on that body. You know what? I've read his bio. You know what it really attracted me to him is his favorite thing to do is golf. Now, it would just be my luck. You know, you hit the ball before the group in front of you has it cleared, and you nail one out there to move him along, and he walks back and said, did you hit that drive?
No, it was my partner.
That's right.
First down at the 46.
Oh, an option that didn't work.
It didn't work at all. Kenny Holmes kind of blows that up again, too. Chris?
Guys, we talked about quarterbacks looking for their receivers, the buddy system. Here we got Fresno State, the Florida State, Arianna Semesson for the touchdown. Kind of a broken play. least you could show some scrambling ability. Good pump fake, too.
Hey, yeah, pumped so bad I almost dropped the ball. But, yeah, I just had to improvise, and he made the play. I mean, you know, it's really his job.
Wayne, so many great receivers at Florida State. What can you do to stand out? Obviously, it's tough to get great stats while you're in school there with all the competition in your own team.
Yeah, you're right. First, I'd like to give thanks to Jesus Christ for giving me an opportunity to play at Florida State. But, you know, it's sometimes hard to stand out when you have a bunch of receivers, but, you know, I've been blessed to be able to make the plays that I've been able to make this year.
Made a play today. Brad?
Made a play that gave the 17-0 lead. The North coming back now. Bo Morgan went over to the tight end, Leshinsky out of Army, and he picks up a first down. And right now the North has a little something working with 9:39 remaining.
See, Bo just going to stick with the military people. And I don't know how far they can get with that. You know,
you're going to have to throw a lot to the tight end, I think.
Right. I'm just going to see another try for that option.
And to give to the first man inside the 40, Keely King. And Akili King, even though he's listed out of Oregon State, he played.
Right, there you go.
See, there you go.
3 years
right.
At Army.
He was at Army for
so
3 years.
It's just we got the, right now, the Joint Chiefs of Staff offense going right here.
And the Commander in Chief trophy that was living out in Colorado at Air Force for so long, and it's not anymore because of the seasons that Navy and Army had.
Whoa. I hope that's eye black.
I hope it is, too.
You know, in a game like this, and I think you know, Navy was out here in the Hula Bowl and played well and won a football game just a while ago. When you don't have great matchups in the offensive line, the option play is the best play you can call. The problem is you got a bunch of guys out there in the offensive line that are trying to show the scouts they can pass play.
Right. That was Clint Bruce out of Navy. We got the whole thing
going,
don't we?
We got a theme going.
We got Army, Air Force, Navy. It's a great place to start, I guess. Second down and 6 to the toss. Kinder waiting for his blocker. Cuts up behind it. It'll be short of the first down. Peters, the linebacker, made the tackle and a motion penalty on the North.
Yeah, I think that time Leshinsky left a bit early as the tight end. He had an arc block, and he just beat the count.
Okay. No, we don't have.
And they'll back this up to the 44-yard line.
On the offense, number 40, 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Left, veer left. No, just left, veer left.
Left, veer left.
Jimmy Armisen, Armisen, next play.
That's the...
Where's Armisen? Archie. Next play. Archie.
The rest of us call him
Amerson. Yeah. But that's okay when you're the coach.
That's right. Yes, sir.
Yeah, exactly. That's what he said. Steve Rosgus said, Coach, you're always mispronouncing my name. He said, that's okay. You can just call me sir. He said, you can call me Steve. And he said, you can call me sir. No gain on that play. And James Kidd bringing in the play.
We don't have anybody else. Okay.
Uh-oh. And he looks out there and sees an offensive lineman. On the field, he's worried that Lou Holtz is. And that is Rayburg.
Now what do you do? Move a tight end inside to play tackle?
Well, I think they still have one more. Dennis Whitmore is going to come in the game. Tim Cohn is the other tackle, but it gets you down where you don't have any substitutes.
Right. And Whitmore is coming on the field now.
And there's still 8:18 in the second quarter of this game. This has been a tremendous amount of plays.
Look at the size of Rayburg. We talked about how big he is. Now, these trainers, obviously,
are not the biggest guys
in the world. They're not holding him up very well, though.
No, they're just doing that for show. It's because you just have to do it, but they aren't doing anything.
Third down and 12.
We might as well get two of the Hooter girls left them off. Usually what happens, and that's what happened on this one, one of his own players rolled up on
the back of his leg. Third down and 12. Morgan. Bowe's going deep down the middle. This one's up in the air and picked off. Intercepted by Anthony Fogle. That just hung up there too long. Bowe might have been hit just as he released it, but way too much air under that one, and Fogle with the interception. So that stops another North attempt to try to get on the board with 8:04 remaining in the first half. South got it back, and they got a big lead.
What's up, Mom? Hey, Sam. down Houston, Texas. Back home, back home.
Now Anthony Fogle with an interception.
Sydney, my baby girl.
He's talking to his baby girl, Sydney, and his wife, Becky, back home watching. He has turned it back over to his team's offense at the 12-yard line. And Otten with a toss to Daniel Ferguson. And Ferguson out to about the 12.
Yeah, Lyron Cobbins, the Notre Dame inside linebacker, made the play on that one. Turned him back inside for the lineman to clean it up. But Cobbins came, ran the play down from inside out, and made it. And that's what linebackers do at Notre Dame. And that's why you make a lot of tackles, and you're their leading tackler.
Did you see a few added stickers on a lot of the helmets out here today? Don't be confused.
I like that. I think Notre Dame should go with that no fear on the side. You think that could pass?
I bet they'll jump right on that. Yeah. Second down. Eight to go. And it's Smith, the fullback. And Emory got out to the 15, maybe out to the 16-yard line. And Rayburg, they're icing down his right ankle.
Rayburg is so big that you're not going to have very many Mai Tais with the amount of ice he's going to use to do that ankle.
That won't fit in a blender.
No.
No. Third down coming up. And a long six. Otten, who hooked up so many times earlier with Chris Miller, his wide receiver from USC. And Miller's out there top of the screen.
He'd be looking for that Freddie Jones if it was me.
Comes back the other way. And Dedrick Ward ran a little bit too far in. The ball went out. Incomplete. It's punting time for the South.
Again, and the short passes look easy, but it's one of the toughest passes to throw. You have to work and have timing with it. That time, Otten.
Don't let out, man!
Where is that guy?
And the receiver, we're not on the same page, obviously.
Russ now set to punt. Inside his own five. They can't bring a lot of steam here on a punter either. They're going to set up the return.
Oh, boy.
End over end kick. He's kicking better than he is punting today. Herring let this one go, maybe shouldn't have. He's got about an extra 12 to 15 yards downfield before it's downed there. And the North trailing by 17. We'll have the ball on offense when we come back.
It. Was it her? What about him? Maybe they did it. Find out in America's longest-running comedy, Sheer Madness, at the Broward Center for the Performing Arts, December 12th through February 2nd. Make your appointment with laughter. Tickets are on sale now. Charge by phone 954-462-0222 or call Ticketmaster today.
Stadium South leading the North 17 to nothing with Gary Danielson and Chris Fowler. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us on what is early afternoon here in Honolulu. Steve Sarkisian, 6 out of 13 so far in this ball game. He's thrown an interception and he's back to throw and a quick out and out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Got it to Brian Manning out of Stanford. And we check in with Chris Fowler. Chris.
Well, I'm Santa Lou Holtz here, who said before the game it was kind of 1AA versus 1A, kind of poor-mouthing his team. But now he's got the odds against him here. He's got injuries down to 5 offensive linemen. You got the deficit, perhaps the talent gap. This is where you want to be, huh?
Well, I tell you what, now I know why I'm not coaching any longer. But, no, we'll be fine. We just have to make a play, catch the ball. I think Steve's done a nice job throwing the ball. We aren't going to have long on protection. We've got to mix up running a little bit. Somebody's got to make a play.
Let's watch this one, Fred.
Quick out. And and complete the kick for the first down of the 41.
Hey, sir, we don't throw a quick out at 2 yards. You show me the guy. Look, lit right. We don't throw a quick out at 2 yards. He catches the ball here and he gets knocked back.
Forward progress not in the All-Star rule book.
How about Lou telling us yesterday he'd like to be a basketball coach? A lot easier. He's already working the official basketball coach.
First down.
Oh, nice call there.
Draw play. And across the 45, Brian Schuster.
Archie.
Bring up second down about 7.
Hey, get one of
Schuster, a former walk-on at Nebraska. And became their fullback in the always talented Cornhusker backfield. Got about 4 there. It'll be second down and 6 coming up.
When you're having problems with the pass rush, Lou Holtz goes right to what you should try to do. A couple quick passes, a draw play, try to keep that pass rush working hard and chasing nothing, basically.
Sarkisian wants to throw a screen. No, throws it across the middle. Amerson made a one-handed catch. Then got leveled by Spain.
That was one of those breakout screens that time where you're trying to throw it to the halfback. The linemen are supposed to let their people go, then get downfield. That's what Steve Sarkisian said to somebody. Amerson did a nice job catching that football that time because it was behind him.
Two Florida State guys in on the stop defensively.
Okay, hold your water. Let's go right, toss, sweep left on 2. Ones, ready?
Hold your water means he's going to try to draw him off.
If they could get him an outside penalty, it'd be an automatic first down.
Ready,
four. There it is.
Very held in water.
Worked beautifully. Everybody's still water-filled. That play's going nowhere, but the penalty's going to give him a first down at about the 47-yard line.
Yep, think. Anytime you have third and less than 5 yards, a quarterback is going to try to get a cheap first down. That time with the cadence, Sarkisian did it masterfully.
Connell Spain, who had made the previous play, jumped. I don't know what Connell's got working there, those long string things.
It's a towel.
Yep, I guess.
Ready, hit!
Jumped in the neutral zone. They walk it off onto the south end of the field with a first down at the 47. It looks like the play's coming in from number 47.
Cracking on that linebacker.
Akili King brings in the play to Steve Sarkisian.
Right, light, swing left, on set. Ready? On set. Light.
At the 47, first and 10 for the North.
On set.
Sarkisian with an interception and touchdown passes yet today. Looking to swing one out. He's ready to Kenny Holmes again.
Somebody got hurt on that one.
Well, now there's some giggling. That's good.
Archie, come on, babe.
Archie went the wrong way that time, Amerson. It was a swing left, and Archie went the other left.
Come on, babe.
When you only got one guy to throw to on a screen pass, and that man goes the wrong way, you got a problem.
And he's not the biggest back in the world there.
That was Kenny Holmes yelling in your face, and that is no fun.
Archie, come on, babe.
Good sequence there. Out of the shotgun with maybe a little more time to throw, maybe not. Sarkisian bouncing around, and down he goes again. This time Rick Terry will get credit for the sack as he hit him low. Terry out of North Carolina with a sack. And this one's going the wrong direction for the North.
Talk to George Perlis and ask him who's the best defensive lineman in this football game. Inside, he likes Rick Terry from North Carolina. And he puts an arm under move just like George Perlis taught at Pittsburgh Steelers for a number of years with Mean Joe Green.
That's right. Coach Perlis, one of the assistants on Bobby Bowden's South team. Former Michigan State head man. Third down in about a mile, 26 to go. Sarkisian incomplete, intended for Josh Wilcox, the tight end. And it's time for the North to give it up. They had a pretty good opportunity there with good field position, and we're actually on the south end of the field, and back-to-back sacks has set them in a 4th-and-26 situation now. you know, almost 50 yards a punt. And Khalid Muhammad way down there on the right-hand side of your screen, inside the 20, waiting for the punt. And he picked a pretty good spot to wait on it because Rialli got all of it again. Fair catch taken at the 12-yard line. The South with the ball and the lead when we come back. 2:38 left first half. Up in Connecticut, both teams looking to get back to the Final Four. That's at 3:30 Eastern tomorrow on ESPN. Arianas, nice play fake, throws out. Emory Smith made a nice catch, and the big fullback goes down the sideline with a first down across the 30 out to the 33-yard line.
And everyone knows Emory Smith can block. Everyone has been proven that he can gain yards. He gained over 700 yards last year as a fullback for Clemson. That catch right there might help him more than anything in this football game. Just showing, as a fullback in the National Football League, it isn't enough just to be a great blocker. You have to be able to sneak out of that backfield and keep linebackers honest, and that's what Smith showed on that play. He has the ability to do it, because that was a tough catch.
First down at the 33. 2.5 to go in the half. Arianas got some pressure from behind, and down he goes. Cameron Curry. Big defensive lineman from Air Force collared him in the back of the pads and wouldn't let go.
Well, for the North, if it hadn't been today for this game, for the Air Force Academy, the Navy, and Army, they would not be making any plays because the academies have been making all the plays. This time, Cameron Curry comes around, gets his right arm just on the shoulder pad, and takes Arianas down.
And ironically enough, they have the least amount to gain from this game because they have the military commitment. Most of these guys, many, will never get a chance to play pro football.
Interesting. We talked to Bo Morgan yesterday, and he said he wants to try pro football. Mm-hmm. He said we talked about his commitment, and he said that he's exploring possibilities of what could happen. And, you know, the other guy in this football game that has a chance is Clint Bruce, the linebacker from Navy, who has been invited to the combine. So two guys who had great careers in college football, Bo Morgan, of course, with all the great stats, and Clint Bruce, the linebacker from the South team, or the North team, excuse me, want to give it a shot.
I remember years ago, Eddie Myers at Navy, the running back, kept going. He'd get his furlough or whatever you call it, the time off in the summer to go to the Atlanta Falcons training camp. Did that 6 years and then finally got a chance to play after that was over. Long ball, hot and intended for, or Arianas rather, for the tight end from USC, and it's incomplete. Well, you put that kind of work in trying to make pro football, and that's what some of these guys, and Chad Hennings has proven it with Dallas, it can be done. Roger Staubach, of course.
Guys from the academies don't know nothing but work, I
right.
think. You can't really say it that way in the academies, but it's the same idea. That probably was the best sequence of plays defensively all game for the North team. They put pressure on the quarterback, good coverage, and stopped a three and out right there and even forced a sack on the play.
Andy Rush to punt. North will have one more shot here before halftime and trying to get some points. Van Washington lets it bounce and lets it go.
See, I don't understand. When you can't rush the punter, why would you just put one guy back? I'd put nine guys back and two guys up.
And then just take everyone.
Make sure I catch the ball.
Let's check in with Chris with 1:25 left in the quarter.
And Brad, after that minute 25, we'll have the new Dodge halftime report. We'll check in with the ESPN News folks, get an update on sports. Salute the AFCA Coaches of the Year, an audience with the draft guru, Mel Kiper, his projections. And you're going to really enjoy this, a reminiscing session with Bobby Bowden and Lou Holtz, whose friendship goes back decades. All that coming up on the new Dodge halftime report. Guys?
A couple of characters, without a doubt. And one will be missed on the college football sideline of the upcoming year.
Hard to think about college football without Lou Holtz involved.
Of course, the other one will be back getting ready to win at least 10 games again for Florida State. Every year that happens.
He can win 10 games if he can win by as many enough points. They're not happy.
Sarkisian now to Kinder out of the backfield. And he's knocked out of bounds at the 19-yard line.
Sarkisian was planted in the end zone after he let that one go. But a two-minute drill with a minute and 18 to go. Let's see what the BYU quarterback can do.
1:18 left.
What?
Second down, about three coming up.
Right weak zone.
Right.
Oh, here we go. Right weak zone right. I'm one out, ready?
1:18 remaining in the quarter. Second down and three for Sarkisian. North offense.
Ready, hit!
King on a cutback. And didn't get much, maybe a yard. And now I think a timeout coming up. Timeout with 108 left and a third down and a couple yards coming up. A lot of fun out here, obviously, plus the work of football and playing, and Lou Holtz wanted to go that way. This was Beach Day Thursday here in Honolulu. You wonder why these guys want to come out here and play.
No, but you're not doing it. You're grinding them into the
sand. They didn't need a lot of volunteers, did they?
No. And, of course, Chris Fowler pretty bummed out that he had to work that day, too. This one always draws a ton of spectators.
Nothing wrong with sand and bikinis.
Do you have a tip for her serving? She's got a great serve. Stay smooth. Don't think too much. Concentrate.
Greg Bellisari with some coaching tips. Look out with that serve. That guy got hit with that and never moved his camera. Did you see that? Line drive hit right toward him. He never moved the camera.
I think he was looking at something else.
I do too. We're looking at a third and two with 108 left in the first half. 51st Hooters Hula Bowl in Honolulu. And the North are there to have any chance to get on the board, have to pick up this first down. Bo Morgan and Steve Sarkisian both out there, so Bo apparently going to play in the backfield here. Although I think they've used up their allotment of option passes, you never know.
I think Bo might be the most dependable running that little option route.
Slant deep on one already.
Quick slant deep. McGuire and Harris, the wide receivers for Sarkisian. Neither with blinding speed, by the way. Yep, not going to get the pass away. And it was Joe Salavea of Arizona. Steve Sarkisian running for his life back there.
Yeah, the mismatch is on the offensive line for the North this time, and they just have not been able to give enough protection for the quarterback in an all-star game. You don't have much time to practice, and you can't pass block. You don't have much of an offense.
Yep. So, fourth down. Bo Morgan out there having a busy day, doing a little bit of everything, that's for sure. As a receiver. And we've seen him catch it. We've seen him on the option on the toss back to Sarkisian. And running pass patterns as well.
He also returned a kickoff in this football game. And now he's going to cover a punt because he's out there now.
Mr. Versatility for Coach DeBerry at Air Force. Fourth down.
Interesting, we talked to him about who's going to be Air Force quarterback next year, and he says little brother.
Little brother, probably. Reale, a long spiral. Dedrick Ward takes it at the 35 and got the sideline. And Ward takes it inside the 40 of the North. Actually, going to spot him out at the 41. 50-yard punt, a 24-yard nifty return here by Ward.
See, I think it makes a lot more sense to have two receivers back in this game. You can't block the punter, and two times in this game, the North team have given up yardage because they've only had one guy back there, and the punt has hit the ground and rolled 15 yards, and that has cost them yardage, and they've not been able to make it up.
So the South could try to capitalize if they'd like here. They got 43 seconds left from the 41. Otten fires, and Miller. Nice play
throw,
by Herring.
Nice route, nice coverage by Kim Herring. That's good football by everybody involved.
Herring has an interception today, and a nice play there against Chris Miller, the wideout from USC.
When you're a quarterback, Brad Otten this time, you're just letting that ball go. You're assuming that your guy's going to be open on that play. You say it's coming. Your job is to get open. My job is to throw it in the right spot. Kim Herring made the play.
Ward and Miller remain the wideouts for Otten. Throw short out of the backfield. Sean Mitchell made the catch and then run out of bounds at the 38. Tatum, the linebacker, ran him out.
One of the question marks about Brad Otten is his size. I don't know if there is that tall of a quarterback in the National Football League, but this time Bill Ennis Inge is going to come around the corner. Watch Otten throw right over the top. That's the advantage. Being able to get rid of that ball. The only guy I can think of that size right now that's playing is Scott Mitchell.
Mm-hmm.
He's not doing bad. He's making about $4 or $5 million a year. I guess it can be done.
I guess so. Brad Otten has picked out Chris Miller as his guy, and as we said, you kind of like bring your own wide receiver. And they hooked up four times early in the ball game and helped the South on their opening touchdown drive.
Hey, you got six. Take six.
12 seconds to go right here, and what they're going to try to do is hit Freddie Jones on a quick option route over the middle. And then they just want him to fall down right away, take a timeout, kick a field goal, and then Brad said, right at the last second, is, you know,
what you want to
if you got
for.
Six.
Right. Freddie, if you can go 53 yards like you did last time I threw it to you.
Yeah. Just go ahead and throw.
We're going to throw it for the
whatever.
The end zone,
whatever.
Right?
Whatever. You just make call on it. Yeah. Now, if we don't make it, can they, we're not giving them one back here, are we?
No.
I'd go ahead and help them.
That's Spike Dykes of Texas Tech talking with Bobby Bodden.
When Spike and Bobby talk, they're just not very, you know, you just want to miss them.
That's a joke waiting to happen, those two guys. Their stories between
timeout,
those two.
Timeout,
got the short
timeout.
Catch, and they did get the timeout at the 30.
That's perfect execution. It's exactly the way you play it. You plan it that way. You had a timeout. You get a field goal kicker one more try, and you tell everybody before the snap. The one thing Brad Otten could have done that I've done in the past is tell the referee before the play that you're going to call timeout, so he's almost looking for you.
Remember, as Chris talked with Andy Russ, the last time he hit a field goal before the one he hit in the first quarter was back in high school and could only find the snapper's rear end when he was at Mississippi State. Well, he hit one from 43 earlier. Now they're going to ask him from 47 if he can make a play on the final play of the second quarter.
And, of course, you're not allowed to block the kick. So it's basically everybody else is just watching out there. We got three guys doing something, the center, the holder, and the kicker, and everybody else gets to watch like us.
But we got to have the guys in the orange jersey stay out there, otherwise it would look funny. 47-yard kick by Andy Russ. And he got another one. Well, not a bad half for a guy that's not normally a kicker. 43 and then 47. And that's the final play of the second quarter. Coming up, the new Dodge Halftime Report right after these messages and an update from ESPN News. Score at halftime. It's all South right now. They lead the North 20 to nothing.
Broken play type plays, and as you look at the statistics, the total offense is swung in the passing yards basically because to the South because of Freddie Jones' big play and the sacks that have really became an important part of this game facing the North.
So it's 20 to nothing, the South in front, and Steve Sarkisian and company hope to change that in the second half. But as we talked about, the offensive line problems have made Steve have to scramble around to get those 16 passes off, and sacked several times when they had an opportunity in the second quarter to get points on the board in South territory. And speaking of Freddie Jones, there he is. The onside kick to start things off to open up the second half.
Have you done that before?
So now we'll see what they do with it.
Never.
Arianis will be at quarterback at the 45-yard line. So opportunity on the south side right here to open things up in the third quarter. Arianis going to throw the quick one inside the 40. Down to the 39-yard line. Khalif Muhammad with the catch. And the third quarter underway.
Jim Arianis signed out of high school with Northern Arizona. Played behind Jeff Lewis there. Transferred, obviously, to Fresno. Had a good blue-gray game. Good size. Both quarterbacks for the South team have good size in this football game. And as the game of the National Football League evolves, the bigger the quarterbacks you are, being able to take those hits from guys like Kenny Holmes is becoming important.
Either that or being able to dodge him like Jake Plummer, huh?
Yeah, you know, that was surprising. You know, not the way Jake played, but I mean, I think that's Jake is going to be just over 6 feet tall, and I think that's going to be the interesting guy in this draft, how Jake really comes out. A couple of guys as quarterbacks as we watch a nice run inside there by David Thompson.
Thompson stopped by Rosga, or he might have been off to the races for a touchdown.
The smaller quarterbacks, the Ty Detmer-type guys, how are they going to play in the National Football League? That's something I think they're going to watch.
Well, Ty's at least had him make and take notice now.
Yes.
Because of what he's done with the Eagles. First down, South, and Amory Smith. on a roll and down inside the 20 to the 17. Bert Berry brought down the big fella. Emery was asked, you know, when you go on and play in the NFL, what would your dream team or your dream job be? Well, I think Moose Johnston would probably have something to say about it. He said, I wouldn't mind being a cowboy and blocking for my big brother.
Well, the Moose is a free agent last time I looked, so
who
you
knows?
Never know.
First down on the run by Smith. 20 to nothing, the South All-Stars lead. And a first and 10 down in the red zone of the North again. Arianis on the give to Staley. This is going to lose about a deuce. Cameron Curry, another nice play defensively.
Well, Bill Innocinge is the guy we talked about that had to have a good football game in this thing. Has not had the big play so far, but he's been forced to do a lot of things. Here he plays off the block to the outside by Adam Meadows, turns it back in and makes a good play. And that's what you do with your play at Iowa. Whether you're an outside linebacker, defensive end, whatever you call it, you got to stop the run of the Big Ten.
We saw him have a huge game against Wisconsin. He had four sacks in that one. Here's Sean Mitchell. He can get to that corner about as quick as anybody. And Washington ran him out of bounds.
This time Adam Meadows says, let me have another chance at you this time. Number 71, the Georgia tackle, gets up in Innocinge's face. Bill gets good depth, but Sean Mitchell just a little too quick, and I don't know where the outside linebacker is, but I think Innocinge right now is saying, where are you? Can't do it all.
As Meadows
started the last 25 games for Georgia in the SEC, all SEC player.
Third down coming up in five at the 12-yard line. As the South looking to add to its lead here a couple of minutes into the third quarter. Arianis going to throw it to the corner. Messam can't get there. And no flag. Kim Herring back there playing it defensively.
Was that a smart play or what? Kim Herring ran to the spot, stopped, and made Messam run right over him to get to the ball. And that's what I think you said. I'm going to bring a little Penn State into the National Football League. A heady football player. Used to playing with the ball up in the air. Doesn't lose confidence. Watch him stop, almost like a basketball player. And if there would have been interference, it would have been on Wayne Messam
yep.
that time.
Keep yourself between the ball and the guy trying to catch it. Great
Absolutely.
Job by Harry.
He did not panic on that play and turned a maybe a potentially disastrous play into 3 points.
Andy Russ.
Andy Russ said this is easy.
This is simple. No rush coming for Russ. 43 and 47 and now chip shot. Good.
Yep.
Got another one. 11 points for this guy today. And it's 23 to nothing.
If you're
The Hooters Hula Bowl is presented by Hooters Restaurants. Delightfully tacky, yet unrefined. And in part by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately?
Now, when they say, you know, it's just another day at the beach, it's actually almost what this is. The South, not a day at the beach for the North right now. Struggling down 23 to nothing as you look. Diamond Head in the distance and here in Aloha Stadium. Kim Herring, who's played extremely well today. But the South leading 23 to nothing. Andy Russ's kick goes to Emerson at the goal line. Emerson out across the 20, got maybe to the 22. That's where the North will go to work. The North had a 31-yard reverse on their first play of the game.
Yeah, and then they had 31 after that.
Well, they haven't had much since then in the last 38 snaps.
88 yards.
88 yards since then.
Yeah, that's what happens when those offensive linemen aren't as stout.
Boy, got that right.
I think that maybe to even this game off, they should tell Kenny Holmes he can go to the beach anytime he wants to.
He's playing right defensive end right now. That's the bad news for the North offense. Sarkisian loading up, going long for Kidd, and it is going to be intercepted by Fogle, his second of the game. That one hung way up there. Now, wait a minute, are they saying that he bobbled it before he landed?
Yeah.
Fogle thought he caught it. He had one in the first half. They're going to bring this back. It'll be second down.
This one was coming down like a pineapple from a palm tree by the time he got over there. This one was up there. I think this one got caught in the trade wind.
Yeah.
Because this one just came straight down, and Fogle said, I caught that baby.
Well, he made a great effort. If he didn't catch it, it sure was a nice
Well, you
attempt.
Know, the ground did help him, I guess. But he did have his hands completely around the football beforehand, I thought. So,
I guess when you're ahead 20 feet to nothing, you don't get those calls.
That's right. That's in the rule book. Sarkisian, second and 10. Goes complete. Short one of Manning.
Hold him up.
Whoa, look out.
Hold him up.
Don't hold him up and let nine other guys take him down. Ricky Parker finally puts the finishing touch.
Had Ricky Parker not pulled Brian Manning away, Joe Salavea would have sent him into the bench that time.
That's right.
Because that was almost like a bull coming. Salavea had him in his sights, and Ricky Parker just moved him out of the way at the last second.
Parker, three-time all-whack performer at San Diego State. We saw him have a good game earlier this year, one of the games we did out of San Diego State.
Watch the end of this play. Parker's going to get him. Manny's going to get upfield. Now watch him yank him out of the way and Salavea. Whoa!
Whoa. Did a little matador thing.
Never saw it coming.
The bull was coming.
Ready, hit!
Third down and six. Holmes is offside. Look out. Sarkisian stripped from behind. I think this one's still going to be the north ball.
See, that's one of the most dangerous plays in football. When the defensive end of the blind side jumps off sides and get a running start, there's no way he can be blocked. Timmy Cohn that time, the tackle head, didn't have a chance, and Sarkisian plays it. That's where the referee has to help you and whistle that play.
Yeah, got to stop that thing as fast as you can.
Offsides on the defense. Number 90, 5-yard penalty, repeat third down.
Watch Timmy.
Kenny Holmes doesn't need a lot of head starts
either.
No,
but this time he gets drawn off sides with a hard count, and then Timmy Cohn, the left tackle, doesn't have a chance to block him. The most he tries to do is to hold on to him, but it's too late. Fortunately, Holmes went around the back end and tried to force a fumble on the play, but, you know, one more whack to Sarkisian's arm, and he's going to start throwing left-handed.
So Holmes has had a couple of big plays.
Kenny Holmes has never had a problem rushing the passer. If he has a challenge, it's just showing that he can stop the run. But if you can rush the passer, you can play in the National Football League.
Kinder, the tailback, in the north eye, and he'll get the call. And Kinder dips for about four near the 35-yard line. Peters, Tyrell Peters, makes another tackle. He's been a busy linebacker today.
Anafa that time, center, number 66 for the north team, and Connell Spain were in a little bit of a tussle at the end of that play. So maybe we should put one camera on those guys because we're going to have some action after this play.
Getting a little hot, and they're getting sick of each other.
That's
down in the
right pit,
I think, with 11 and a half to go, third quarter.
And they're lined up about a foot from each other.
Here's a toss sweep to Kinder, trying to follow Akili King, who got part of a block, but Anthony Fogle, tell you what, the kids from Oklahoma are playing well today. The defenders made a couple big plays, almost had an interception earlier in this drive, and did have one in the first half.
Anthony Fogle is a high school quarterback. So if you get those guys that come out of high school being a quarterback, you're comfortable with guys throwing the ball. I've always liked the defensive backs that can play on both sides of the ball. If I was wanting to put a team together, I would have people that are comfortable with the ball in the air, and Anthony Fogle obviously is.
Third down play. Third down at six.
Ready, hit!
Sarkisian has a little trouble with a snap, and now he's going to have trouble because he's been hammered again. Vantuone and Salavea, a couple of Arizona Wildcats, are there to meet at the quarterback.
Well, it's not exactly Desert Swarm out here, but it's the forest fold, I guess, because the line has been folding in front of Steve Sarkisian.
It's been a long day for the BYU quarterback because of just a lack of time trying to throw the football.
Got to give Sarkisian a lot of credit, staying in there and taking all that and lining back up and isn't doing any belly aching, just playing football.
Fifth sack of the day. Reale, used to kicking in the dome, is kicking pretty well in the warm weather today, and he blasts this one too. Fair catch, way back at the 19-yard line by Dedrick Ward. Another 49-50-yard kick. Timeout with 9:53 remaining in the quarter. Lou Holtz down 23 to nothing.
And Ender, we didn't get any wimpy barbecue sauce, which is why whenever we put something on the barbie, we make sure it's smothered with Jackaroo barbecue sauce. Jackaroo's got a bold and zesty taste as big as the Australian outback. So go on, mate. Pour it on chicken, ribs, shrimp, or steak, or use it in a bowl for a dip. Jackaroo barbecue sauce. It's the wonder from down under.
Jackaroo barbecue sauce. Big taste from a big place.
More than 7 million Americans trust their retirement savings to Fidelity Investments. One reason is our passion for helping people realize their retirement goals. In fact, our retirement specialists will happily guide you through all your investment options, day or night, to help you plan for a secure, comfortable retirement. And that should be a great comfort to you right now. Visit our branches or our website, or call 1-800-FIDELITY for a free retirement planning guide.
This is Ford Escort. It's new and it's nifty. It's made for the smart, the intelligent thrifty. It's new out and in, has airbags for two. Even anti-lock brakes are available. Ooh, the trunk, it is huge to hold tremendous treasure. And if your treasure is of stupendous measure, the rear seat folds down to let bigger things in, still leaving room for your next of kin's kin. It has all the what's-its and gidgets, to put it concisely. And Escort's right price should suit you quite nicely.
Gorgeous George. George Perlis, ex-Michigan State head coach, in his element here with his defensive lineman. He is something else, isn't he?
One of the great characters of college football, of course, pro football with the Pittsburgh Steelers. He made his name coaching the Steel Curtain defensive line.
Now heavily involved in the new bowl game that's going to be going on up in your neck of the woods. Brad Outen back to throw and fires out to his tight end, John Allred. And Allred takes it out across the 40. His first catch of the day, and these USC quarterbacks, you can say one thing, they know who to throw to, their own teammates. Pick up a 21.
Allred only caught 27 passes this season, but 10 of them were in one game against Houston.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll bet he was lobbying all halftime. Come on, Brad, find me.
Yeah, I was the captain of our team, man. There he is. Out of Del Mar, California, 6'4", 245.
And Chris Fowler mentioned when he was talking to Freddie Jones that this was a very strong draft at the tight end position, and I think John Allred is one of those guys he's talking about.
Cotton draw play, and that one doesn't net much. Sean Mitchell. That's blown up by Finkus and Elzey.
Yeah, Myron Elzey is the guy that I think is real guy to look at. Not a lot of us know a lot about him, to be honest. He's from Central State of Ohio. He's gotten a personal trainer since the season ended, taking his weight from 335 pounds down to 305. And he said he will be ready for the combine. He's going to be ready to make an impact. A former high school running back.
Wow.
I like those guys.
Otten on second down and long. Scans the field and throws incomplete.
Oh, he gave it a Bernie Kosar throw that time.
Staley was the closest guy. Finkus in there again. So was Kafusi. Those two combined to put a lick on him after he let go of the ball.
Matt Finkus coming around the outside. Adam Meadows has got him, but Finkus refuses to stay blocked as he keeps shifting his weight and gets out. Ooh.
Oh.
That is one that you just don't like. And look at Finkus say, I didn't mean to do it. I was stumbling. It was just one of those things.
24 sacks, second all time.
Not going to be the same watching Ohio State without Vrabel and Finkus.
Boy, that's for sure. Hot.
Uh-oh.
On third down. Streak down the sideline for Miller. And out of bounds. He made the catch and held on. Joe Gordon played it well, though. Kept him between him and the sideline and just kind of forced him out there at the end of the play. It's incomplete.
Joe Gordon is another one of those veteran college football players. Matched up with a pretty good corner on the opposite side of the field.
Chris Canty.
But Joe is a three-year starter, has covered a lot of great Big 8 and now Big 12 cornerbacks. But this time, very smartly, knows the ball is near the sideline and pushes Miller outside. And at Kansas State, you get used to playing a lot of man-to-man coverage with their package. Again, only one receiver back, and they've not been able to handle the ball. They've been bouncing all over. It's going to happen again.
Yep, there it goes again. Kim Herring has to let it go, and it's going to be all the way down to the 4-yard line.
I tell you, a lot of strategy on that north side, but one of them should think of putting two guys back there.
I agree. Maybe. Way down in a hole, and in a hole on the scoreboard as well now. It's 23-0.
You're on the 5. Now you can't get a sack. Hey.
Kawasaki 1100 SPX watercraft even comes with its own retractable reboarding step. An industry first. Yes, that gives us a definite leg up on the competition.
Join the crew, the Kawasaki crew. Own a Kawasaki jet ski watercraft with zero down. No interest, no payments till September 1st of 97. Offer ends soon. Join the crew.
See your nearby participating Kawasaki dealer.
Tell you something, it's all about new ideas, right? Because we got to stop this guy. This guy's flipping so fast. I'm flipping so fast, I don't know what I'm watching, right? But wait a minute, what's that? Michael Chang, Snoop Doggy Dog doing a crazy breakdance, popping a freaking number? What is it? I don't know, but I stopped flipping. I'm watching the ESPYs, and I like it.
The 1997 ESPY Awards, live February 10th at 7:30 p.m., presented by No Fear and General Motors.
I've never seen this before. Good, okay, how about some of this? What's this? What's this?
There's a little time for things you don't normally get a chance to do during the regular season, signing autographs during timeouts. 23-0. The South signing more than the North right now. The North starting at the 5-yard line again. Sarkisian in his own end zone. Look out. And he has to scramble back to take a crunch at the original line of scrimmage back at the 5-yard line. Steve Sarkisian. Playing here, Danny Werfel, the Heisman Trophy winner, only played the first series. The reason that he only played one series is what happened in the game for the national championship against Florida State out of the shotgun. And the shot he took after that pass, an injury that lasted much of that game. And he's such a tough sucker that really nobody knew about it too much until he came out here. And Chris Fowler's with him down on the sideline. I'll be talking to him in just a moment. 7:50 left third quarter. Sarkisian, little quick opener to Schuster, the fullback. And he got about two or three, ran into Peters out of Oklahoma. As we get on to Chris and Danny, guys.
Yeah, Brad, you can see the remnants of that hit you took in the trigger ball. There's still a little bit of a bruise in the back of your right arm, and all Gainesville held its breath when you got hit in the second play out here. But you're okay from that one?
Oh, yeah, doing fine. Just want to get out there and be a part of the game. You know, want to kind of hold on the shoulder till we get, you know, get back to Gainesville, make sure everything's straight, have the doctors look at it, be in the best shape possible for the combines.
Yeah, February 6th, are you going to be ready to make the throws the scouts are going to want to see in about 2.5 weeks?
Definitely. Well, you know, you got to do what you can, and I'll get back and hopefully get in shape, throwing, warm the arm up, and get everything going and be ready to go top shape at the combines.
Ironic that Bowden coaches you in this game. Has he been trying to pick your brain, trying to learn the Florida passing game in this week here in Hawaii?
We've had a lot of fun talking about different things, different plays and all, and he's a great motivator. He kind of steps back and let Coach Dykes kind of run the offense. He's a defensive coach on the defense, and it's going real well.
He's too modest to say it, guys, but he has put in some plays here, kind of a little curl to the weak side. It's about 8 for 8 so far, so you can maybe a future in coaching sometime down the line.
I don't know. It's fun being out here, but Coach Berger's taught us well there at Florida.
Congratulations on your engagement. Jennifer, you had a good week out here?
Thanks. It's been great. We just had it out here, actually. I haven't announced it yet, but thank you.
Thank you.
The world, and when we get back, we'll have to tell everybody about it.
Uh-oh. I guess that was one of those off-the-record things.
I hope he asked. I hope he asked Jennifer. Maybe he hasn't asked her yet. Boy, what a class kid. Not only the Heisman Trophy, but the Dratty Trophy is the top scholastic athlete in the country on top of being the top football player. That is not a bad combination. Muhammad with a fair catch on a high towering punt taken back at the 42-yard line. South with excellent field position and a 23-0 lead.
Brad, there's been a good battle going on in this offensive line for the North. Pat Anafa, number 66, against Canel Spain. They have been squared off, and Anafa, I'll tell you what, Spain has had enough of you. I've had just about enough of you.
Enough of you, boy.
Now, I just, at the end.
There we go. Right. Okay. That's great.
I just had about enough of you.
There he is.
Of course, he spent a whole career blocking for Troy Davis on running plays, and he's showing today that he can be stout enough to pass block. Been very impressed with his game today.
Deuce Daly on a toss sweep, and not enough blocking out in front of him. He's going to lose about 4 yards. Nate Davis helped out on the stop.
Of course, Nathan Davis is the big defensive end from Indiana. All-American shot putter. It's not going to help much in a pro game, but he has shown that he can play defensive end good enough. And with his size, he had 20 tackles for losses this year for Indiana.
That kind of size, as you said, 285 on a 6'5 frame. Pro people love that.
And he is not a big workout warrior.
Right.
I think there's a lot of potential in that body for Nathan Diggs.
Arianna's throwing deep, intended for his tight end Jones. Overshot him. Jones, who had one of the big plays of this game, a 53-yard touchdown earlier in the ball game. That one a little too high for him.
Two names that we have not mentioned much in this football game that but have had to play every play have been Rozga and Logan. Strong safety and free safety. There's only four DBs on the field, and one of the best football players, I think, is going to be one of those 10 or 12 year NFL players is Steve Rozga.
Boy, and he plays hard off the field too. Yeah, that much. Part of the Rozga family that produced three defensive backs played collegiately. One brother still playing, another one who played at Minnesota. His younger brother playing at Wisconsin. And then Tim here at Colorado and out here in Honolulu.
Khalif Muhammad that time, the wide receiver from Baylor, matched up man-on-man on Kim Herring. Probably ran one of the nicer routes. Herring had inside technique, man-to-man all over the field. And Muhammad, who we've seen play before, very quick running back. You see Herring top of the screen, inside technique. He gets turned around, and that's a good route. When you can turn Kim Herring around, you know that Muhammad did a good job running that route.
So the South back in Northland at the 46-yard line. Smith straight ahead, which is what he does pretty well. Talking to some of the scouts the other day about Emory Smith and his potential at the next level in the NFL. They say he's not going to give you much except straight ahead, but he does that straight ahead stuff pretty well.
I'll bet there's a lot of scouts that are hoping that Emory Smith doesn't have a great game. He's been a little bit nicked up this year with shoulder problems and back problems, but I think everyone knows about Emory Smith. Everybody was kind of hoping to get him third, fourth, fifth round. He does too well, and he starts sneaking up the draft.
And, of course, his brother, Emmett. A lot was made about his returning to Florida every year in the offseason to finally get his degree. And little brother Emory's already graduated. He graduated last month from Clemson. So he's all ready to just take all his efforts now into trying to play pro football. It'll be second down, make it third down. 10 with 4:39 at the clock running in the third quarter. 23-0. The South All-Stars lead the North All-Stars here in the Hooters Hula Bowl, 51st edition of this event. Muhammad and Messam, the wideouts for Jim Arianis. Looked right, came back to the left, and completes it in front of Herring, and another good catch by Muhammad. Muhammad out of Baylor, not the big guy, in fact, the smallest guy in the field at 5'6", about 178 pounds.
When you're throwing the ball inside, the quarterback's job is to get it around the linebackers. This is the guy he's going to throw the ball off. Watch the quarterback look outside, and it'll take one step, and there's the hole opening up. You get a linebacker froze to the outside, and there's the lane inside. You know the quarterback did a good job with his eyes looking out. At Fresno State, you throw the ball out of balls, you got to look off.
Here he is, wanting to throw a quick out. Now look out from behind. You got to have eyes in the back of your head for that
one. He should have looked off that time. That was Keenan Tatum from Notre Dame that time. Covered to the outside. Joe Gordon did a good job of covering Wayne Messam. Coverage sack. They were trying to throw short, and Tatum came right in and make the play. Joe Gordon in the bottom. He's going to squeeze on that play. There's no one to throw to. Arianis does a good job of saying, getting out of the way.
Tatum was kind of hoping he could
the play. Yeah,
kind of hoping he could direct him to go out and up, but he didn't have enough time to do the out and up
and
gesture.
You know, all those looking off, that doesn't slow the rush down.
Not at all.
That's Sarkisian.
Second and 18, right down the middle of the tight end and broken up.
Rozga.
Steve Rozga. We told the story briefly before. Steve Rozga said Coach Holtz continued to mess up his last name. He finally said, Lou, you can just call, he said, you can just call me Steve. Coach Holtz says, you can just call me Sir, and we'll get along fine. There he is. Got the newly shaved head, although it's been that way most of the season. Actually wore a wig in the picture they had in the media guide of Colorado, and everybody thought he had hair down to his shoulders. It was some wig he has in the trunk of his car for a special occasion.
Played defensive back for Colorado as a true freshman. Got to be a pretty good athlete.
Down the middle, Jones is open again. Rozga is going to have to bring him down. Fred Jones, he's making himself known here. 255-pound tight end out of North Carolina.
Perfect call for the perfect play right here because the defense was rotating away. You'll see Rozga go to the center of the field. This guy's coming up. You bring Jones up there. That's a seam pass against a zone. There's the wide open play. Just zip it right in there. Rozga does not have a chance. Free safety to get over there late. Every time. See Rozga? I got deep middle. I'm looking for those deep wide receivers. Oh, man, Freddie Jones.
Yep. Here he comes again. Grab where you can and try to bring him down. Three catches, 87 yards, and a touchdown for Jones.
The running game for the South appears to just be kind of a waste of time, to tell you the truth. I think they're just being nice when they call one. It is not working.
Lyron Cobbins and Ennis Inge knocked that play backward.
I don't think you get very nervous when you play for Bobby, do you?
Nope.
The pace is smooth. Built a tremendous program by getting players and letting them play, I think.
Of course, a quarterback derby probably next year for Florida State.
Yeah, that'll be interesting. Mm-hmm. Dan Kendra, Ted Busby.
Ariana's going to throw to the corner for Muhammad. He can't quite get there. Gordon does a nice job kind of staying with him all the way down the field.
He did. He made it too tough of a throw, and Bill Ennis Inge, the guy we talked about, made it too tough of a throw also. Coming from the right side, sets up outside, gets inside Brandon Kidd, and then just puts his sights on the quarterback. And Ennis Inge, again, is just one of those guys that, you know, maybe he's a tweener at 256 pounds. You know, he's not a linebacker. He's not a defensive end. What is he? He just makes plays.
Yeah, exactly. And you can talk to all the scouts in the world, and we have respect for what they do. But
sure.
Sometimes they get a little too 40 and vertical jump conscious. Every time we've done an Iowa game, the guy's been all over the field. I mean, I think some guys can just play football. Arianas scrambling around, running for his life, and tracked down by Burt Berry out of Notre Dame. The Notre Dame linebackers playing pretty well.
They really are. Burt Berry led the Notre Dame in sacks with 10 of them, and there was no way Arianas was going to outrun him. And I guess the MVP might be trotting on the field.
And that would mean Andy Russ is coming back out after this play by Berry. Will force a field goal attempt. And so far, he's perfect today. Normally the punter at Mississippi State. Bob Thalman's a player selection committee guy for the South team. He called Jackie Sherrill and said, you know, I need a kicker. He says, well, take my punter. He can do it all. Well, he's done it all today. 43, 47, 29. And the extra points after touchdown as well. Let's see how he does here.
Gee.
This one might have pushed a little. No, he made it. He made it.
You know, he said his first kick at Mississippi State was low and hit the butt. Maybe it was a bad hold.
Could have been a bad hold.
He had one kick.
Maybe it was a bad snap.
That's
and
right.
He was paying him back. Who knows? Perfect today, though. And the 31-yard field goal tacks three more onto the South lead. They lead 26 to nothing. Don't forget, you can catch wall-to-wall full field of Super Bowl week from New Orleans on ESPN, ESPN2, and ESPN News. All week long, we'll cover everything. We're talking everything. Media day, all the press conferences, the practices, the parties, the food, the halftime preparation, Super Bowl highlight shows from NFL Films, and, of course, complete analysis of the Packer-Patriot matchup right up until the start of Super Bowl 31. Check your local listings. Stay tuned to our ESPN network of your choice, and we'll get you ready for Super 31 in the Crescent City. Let's check in with Chris.
One of the guys who's been a character here at Clint Bruce of Navy, they nicknamed him Old Navy. Interesting story, guys. This happened when he came here for the Aloha Bowl and the Hula Bowl. Staying at the hotel, forgot his key, locked out of his room. Most of us might go down to the desk, get a duplicate key. Not Mr. Bruce. He goes out 17 stories up, scales around three or four balconies, and goes in the sliding door. This is a guy that wants to be a Navy SEAL or a Marine Special Forces recon guy. And you can see it fit.
Chris, I want that guy protecting me, though.
Uh-huh.
I feel safer already, I'll tell you the truth.
Bo Morgan, about 27 yards on the kickoff return. And those balconies, they're not close together. Trust us.
I can't even look over the edge of mine. That's why I guess I'm not going to be a Navy SEAL.
Well, I tried that last night, and it didn't work. So here he comes down on the kick coverage.
I think everybody's getting a little bit tired in this football game. There's been a lot of plays, and you got to play defense and run down on kickoffs. And plus, you got to climb balconies all week. You know, I mean, your legs just give out.
I'm with Chris. I'll go back down to the desk, get another key.
Ready, hit!
Bo Morgan on a little draw play out of the shotgun. Bo got the seam and then got seamed about there by
Clarence Thompson. That time came up. Now, Clarence Thompson's interesting story. Out of Michigan, played for Michigan for a couple years, has transferred now.
Knoxville College.
But Bo is running this play the way you're supposed to. Truck a trailer, watch, follow Ollie King, then turn it up and avoid the safety.
Look out. Thompson's made some nice hits today.
He really has. Played corner and safety for Michigan and has the body and speed to play in the National Football League.
Second down and about eight.
Same play the other way. Is it a throwback pass? No, it is.
Joe Saladaya says, nope, not this time.
You heard that old theory, if it works one way, why not just run it the other way? Well, I don't know.
Didn't work very well.
Hey, quarter!
Tyrell Peters is shaking up, too. He's made a lot of plays today. Comes out favored his right shoulder. As the quarter comes to a close, we've played three, and still the South dominating the North. 26-0 at the end of the third.
Places you can go on the internet, the fact that you don't need a computer to get there. Web TV from Philips Magnavox. The internet now on your television at an affordable price.
Precious Hotline, what's your problem?
We're stuck with Skunky.
Beer.
So it's not Budweiser?
No.
Remain calm, sir. We're on our way.
Next time, look for this.
New Born on Dating from Budweiser. Because fresh beer tastes better.
Precious Hotline.
Could we order some Chinese?
Green Acres is the place to be. Farm living is the life for me.
But give me Park Avenue.
The chores.
The stores.
Fresh air.
Times Square.
Ford Explorer. It's at home, anywhere.
Send email, get sports scores, find dinosaurs. Is something missing? Exactly. The computer. Web TV from Philips Magnavox. The internet now on your television at an affordable price.
Brad, a special thanks to these two ladies in tribute to the way we got ready for this game. This is how we did our studying for 3 days here.
Feet up. Fourth quarter set to start from Honolulu. Brad Nessler, Gary Danielson, and Chris Fowler with you. 26-0. The South leads the North, and looks like some motion on the right side of the line. Malapiea with what Gary would call a pucker there on the
And Malapiea has got the shirt out, too. He's got the Coy Detmer look going right
here.
Well,
he weighs 340. That shirt might not fit in those pants.
Might not go in. That's a problem.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense, number 66, 5-yard penalty.
And his number actually was 73, the guy that moved. And there you see a shirt coming out.
Could be 173 on Mossy's body there, Atassi's body there.
That's right.
So they'll back it up. What they don't need to do is go in the wrong direction. Third down now at 11. Again, the offensive line decimated by injuries, not only today, but in the week leading up to this game, as Chris Nioli, not only one of the best linemen of this game, one of the best linemen in college football. Also out from the virus, another Colorado player.
Ready, hit.
So that depleted him before the game ever even got started. Sarkisian has trouble with a snap, picks it up and looking for a place to go. Cross his body to Bo Morgan. Bo got a first down. Oh, and then James Hamilton hit him. Well, this multi-purpose stuff, Bo's probably thinking, I don't know, maybe.
I don't know.
Maybe being a pilot would be a better idea.
Look who was the one guy who figured out a spot, an empty spot, for Sarkisian to find him. That was Bo Morgan, a heads-up player. And you know what Bo says? I've run the option. If you run the option, you can take any hit in college football. But, boy, James Hamilton showed him a hit.
He hopped right up, didn't he?
Yep.
Which he did
because
so many times.
That was a crash and burn.
Uh-huh.
Ready, hit!
First down out of the gun. They fake the
got
draw.
The tight end.
And go to the tight end.
Got
and again, the service academy showing up.
Got the armed services offense going again.
Yep. Air Force before and then Army. Leshinsky, Ryan Leshinsky, the tight end. There's been some hitting in this game, no doubt about it, whether it's an all-star game or not.
Started out early and it really hasn't stopped in this football game. When you've got defensive players on a field and you've got a chance to get some hits, they hit.
In the third quarter, Bo took another one from Thompson, but he always holds on. He always pops up.
Ready, hit!
Again, they go with a draw play out of the shotgun.
I can promise you that Anafa, number 66, the center, Pat Anafa, out of Iowa State, hasn't done a shotgun snap in a long time with Troy Davis on that football
team. I doubt it. That's right.
So this is new.
Let's go, fellas. Let's go now.
And I think he's playing an outstanding football player in this game. He's played center and guard, and I think he's got a future.
Helping lead the way to Troy Davis's 2,000-yard-plus seasons. And Troy would be the first one to tell you, without guys like that, never have had 2,000-yard-plus seasons. On a second down, here's Bo Morgan cutting back the other way and run down by Lewis Adams, Oklahoma State Cowboy linebacker out of Pontiac, Michigan.
Lewis Adams is another interesting guy. He started out at Oklahoma State as a tailback, moved to free safety, and ended up at outside linebacker. He's either eating well or getting bigger in the weight room, one of the two. But when you have speed, they'll find a place for you on the football field.
And it brings up third down.
Yeah,
and a five to go. Sarkisian, will they look for Morgan?
Yep.
Yeah. Bo couldn't hold that one. Same collision. Lewis Adams and Bo Morgan again. Incomplete.
Definite four down territory when you're behind by 26 to nothing. But he put the ball in the option
on,
route
fellas,
right in the right spot.
Out here.
Bo is going to read the secondary. Sarkisian is looking at the same thing. Bo, catch the ball. You're going to get hit anyway. This time, just a bit out in front of him, Bo says, I remember Hamilton found me last time. I think I'm going to find him this time.
I'm sick of these outside linebackers.
Right.
Steve Sarkisian, you might have heard the huddle. Come on, fellas, somebody's got to make a play. Let's see if they can make one on fourth and five. They'll keep it on the ground. Archie Emerson in his secondary. Goodbye. Touchdown.
Woo!
Well, that's what got him the Peyton Award.
He's even going to get a handshake from the other team on that one. Ray Austin said, that's quick.
38 yards in a hurry.
You know, I think Archie Emerson was a little bit nervous with this game, and you can't blame him when it started. He's playing against guys he's been watching on TV. Remember, he's a division lower, and this time he squirts through a nice block up front by Brian Schuster. Once he gets to the secondary, wow.
Serious speed out there.
And guess who had another base block on that one? My man, Anafa. I might not go the right way on the screen pass, but give me the ball. Give me the ball.
Sean Rialli in for the point after, and first seven of the day on the board for the North. Courtesy, Archie. He couldn't even find Veronica on this one. He was running so fast.
Hooters Hula Bowl is brought to you by Naturally Fresh Salad Dressing Sauces and Dips. 100% natural, 100% delicious. And by ITT Sheridan Hawaii. Our world revolves around you.
Surf's up. Waikiki Beach, and a look at somebody catching a pretty good wave. Here comes an onside kick and a wave of South defenders within 10 yards of the ball. The good hands group is up there awaiting the kick coming up.
I don't think they had enough guys on the field for the North team that time. And also, they didn't back up and get a running start. They were standing right on the line. I think you got to get back and time it so you can hit that thing on the dead run.
Sure, right, right, left.
I want to line up the same way.
Okay.
When he blows that whistle, you 25 seconds.
Okay.
You tee up. You right back after I give you the go. You tee up for play. You tee that thing over their heads. And those people on the right side, you get down. You line up just like you did.
All right, they're going to try a little bit of a pooch onside kick to try to get over the wave of about 10 players.
We're not bleeping Lou out.
No, that's just a short.
Yeah, it's just a short. I think all those players are just blocking transmission. See, we're...
they're not conductors.
No, he's got to go up off a satellite here.
That's right.
What he's going to do is line up the same way and do something different.
Right here.
I think he meant it tipped his hand, though, because on the other side of the field, I think that Bobby Bowden says, hey, we're a little... Oh, wait a second. They're going to switch it the other way. There's Spike Dykes, I think.
That's Bobby.
Oh, that's Bobby. Bobby smells a rat here.
Yep.
I'll tell you that right now. He's coached against Lou Holtz before. He said, I think something's going here. Now, this ball, instead of kicking it, he's going to lob it downfield and try to chase it down.
Now they tee it up. See how Riala does with the kick. High. We got it up there. And the ball is loose. Freddie Jones coming down.
I don't think that's what Lou wanted. I think he wanted to kick it downfield.
About the 35
About the 30-yard line. Let it bounce around.
Now you tell me exactly what I tell you to do. You correct me what I go say. You just line up like it's an onside. He says ready. You set the ball up, and you kick it high to the right. To the right. Did I not say that everybody's here? Kick it down to the... We did it.
Now, maybe that is being bleeped out.
You just do.
No, I don't think so.
You do. I'm not to go out. No, no, we're doing.
Yeah, see. You're right. I think that he wanted to kick it downfield. He said the other way, the other right.
Your other right.
The other right. And here comes the lob. Now, see.
And there was a flag down to boot.
That didn't work out.
Nope, didn't work.
Good idea, bad execution.
And they're still walking off yardage. Whoa.
See, because I think John Allred that time signaled for a fair catch, and then he was interfered with, and that's why they're going to give a 15-yard penalty on top of it.
All the way down to the 37-yard line after all that, with 12:39 left in the
little thought, ball. Lou handled it much better than Lee Corso did, though, when he had a couple problems with special teams 2 years ago.
Coach Corso has been here this week with us. We saw him a few times. Amory Smith straight ahead. LZ in on the tackle. Let's check in with Chris Fowler.
Well, Lou Holtz has explained to me what you're trying to do with that onside kick there.
When you look where they were, he said you lined up, they're all going to be there. Then when they blow the bomb play, you set up straight, you kick it deep right, nobody's there, then we'll run down there and try to outrun them. And if we don't get it, they're going to get the ball on maybe the 15 or the 20. But I didn't make it abundantly clear, obviously.
You need the 9-point rule in this game, which they used to have in a Hula Bowl. You get the ball back.
I was ahead of a 31-7 in the fourth quarter, and we never got the ball in the fourth quarter. But, it would be nice. But, they're playing awful well over there. Our players are playing hard. We just let the punts bounce. They run theirs back. There are a lot of things on it.
Archie Emerson, the guy who scored the touchdown, he's impressed you with his ability this week.
Well, he has great quickness, et cetera. He just needs to have a little bit more awareness. He catches the ball well. He's got great quickness.
Hang in there, Lou. Enjoy your year off, okay?
Thank you.
If there is one.
You know, Brad, I know that Lou might want that ball back, but I'm not so sure Sarkisian would like the ball back all that
so
much. It's been a rough afternoon. If he onside kick it, got it, Steve would have picked, I think, he'd go out there and throw.
Looked like Fink has jumped offside as Otten got a free one and goes complete out to Chris Miller as wide receiver. Joe Gordon bumped him out of bounds. And will they take the play or the penalty? We'll see here in a second.
Otten is going to take the play. I'll tell you that right now. I'll just bet you he's going to take the play. I got a completion.
I don't know how much difference there was.
Who cares?
Offside on the defense, number 90. Penalty is declined. First down.
It's a quarterback mentality.
You bet. Don't ever take away a stat that I just gained.
29.
There we go. 5-eye, 28 sweep crack.
101, right?
Will be Danielle Ferguson in the backfield behind Emory Smith. What is set to be a sweep. And he takes it outside. His blocker goes inside. He loses a couple of yards.
And Matt Finkus again did a nice job to the outside, just forcing that play. The defensive end taking a wide grab, making that play pushed up. Nothing there.
Coming up this week's stop on the PGA Tour, Scottsdale, Arizona. Join us Thursday and on through the weekend for the Phoenix Open. Defending champs Phil Mickelson and Tiger Woods just might show up. He always seems to, fresh off a playoff win at the Mercedes Championships last week. Coverage starts 4 o'clock Eastern Thursday, concludes with a final round Sunday night here on ESPN. And, of course, if that thing goes to a playoff, Tiger only needs one shot usually to win those things. Incomplete. I'm not sure I might want to be a wide receiver on this team when Brad Otten's in the game.
Well, he can throw the ball.
No, but I'm talking about he's throwing it to the same guy.
Oh, I got you.
Let's share the wealth here a little bit.
That is true. Started off the game that way, too. It went to his favorite player and just kept pumping it to the outside, Chris Miller. He said, hey, I got the ball, and I'm putting it to the guy I want to put it to. Went inside, went outside, went short. Not bad.
5 and a 70 pass. Y option 101, right?
Well, this is the play they hit the touchdown
on. Too.
On a third down. Third and 13. Otten, whoa, no option there. That was Burt Berry. The only option was going down. And Ennis Inge is there, too. And fourth down coming up.
Well, what do? You take the field goal and rub it in, or you just try to run a play?
I know they're staying on the field. The offense is staying out there, so apparently that's what they're going to do. Kind of a no-win situation here when you're up 26-7.
We'll score a touchdown, wait. You got a play for me?
5S, 70 pass,
4 verticals, 101, right?
That means all four of the eligible receivers will run up the hash marks inside and the outside. Right up the field.
Brad Otten says we'll pick up the first down and get a touchdown. All in one play. Let's see what he does. Throws short to Staley, and they're not going to get the first down. Deuce gets it back close to the original line of scrimmage at about the 25, and that is where the North will take over. With 9 minutes and 22 seconds remaining in the ball game, North trailing 26-7. We've got a timeout, and the North will go back to work when we come back. 26-7, the South leading the North with 9:22 left in the ballgame. And as you go across to the north sideline, that's James Kidd in that number 56 Colorado jersey.
Yeah, a tribute to his teammate Tyrone Tiger Bussey, who unfortunately less than a couple of weeks ago lost his battle to leukemia. And as a tribute to their teammate, they're going to bring number 56 out of the field.
It's a nice touch. We'll develop that a little more here as we go. Sarkisian looks like an end around coming. It is. Marcus Harris got around one man and then didn't get back to the line of scrimmage. James Hamilton ran him out of bounds.
The flank. Okay. Give me a split left.
Let's check in with Chris right now. Chris?
Yeah, guys, here comes James Kidd wearing the number 56 Colorado jersey that Tiger Bussey would have worn. He never played a down of football for Colorado, but certainly touched many of his teammates there. Made a big impact. At one point, looked like he might win that battle with leukemia, made it back to campus and try to get the football career going, but ultimately, leukemia, too tough an opponent, and as a tribute, the two Colorado players left in this game, Kidd and Steve Rosga wanted to send out a special hello to Tiger's family and a tribute with the jersey today.
Tiger's got a better seat than all of us, maybe, huh? First down toss out to the 35-yard line. Manning makes the catch with 9:09 left in the ballgame. And they move the sticks out to the 35-yard line.
Left. ISO left on 1-0, right?
Sarkisian is Taking some big hits today.
Set!
Still hanging in there.
Ready, hit!
And Kinder goes down, and it's the two Arizona guys again. They're playing pretty well when they're in there together. Van Tuenay and Joe Salavea.
Yep. Salavea, inside player, Tuenay outside. Spain in there also, just tough to block up front. And I really got to give a lot of credit to this North offensive line. They have five guys playing. They've had to fight this whole football game. That is tough out here in Hawaii. For some of them, it might have been, you know, 6-8 weeks before they even they played a game.
That's right. Second down, 10 to go. There's the offensive group. Sarkisian has to scramble again, trying to find a receiver on the run, and he'll just do what he can and go out of bounds near the 40-yard line. Picked up about five. It'll be third down and five as Lorenzo West ran him out of bounds. 1997 Australian Open continues later tonight on ESPN and ESPN2. Start of week two. Some great early round upsets last week, including Boris Becker bowing out of the first round. Steffi Graf just yesterday, but still a lot of big names involved. Number one seed Pete Sampras is there. So's 11 seed Jim Courier. And the women's number four seed Martina Hingis still in action. The highlight matches at 1 o'clock Eastern all week long on ESPN2. As we continue our coverage of the 97 Australian Open.
Ready, hit!
Third down at five for Steve Sarkisian. His tight end was open for a minute. Now he's going to have to try to find somebody who still is, and he still found the tight end open. Out to the 50-yard line, Ron Leshinsky just kind of trying to find himself a dead spot in there, and does, and picks up the first down.
All right. Fullback stays in on big. You want me to go out, I go out.
All day long, yeah. There's been confusion about which way to go for those backs and who's going to block.
That's one of those problems you have as a quarterback. You start yelling at everybody, and then you find out it's your fault. You were wrong. Oh, yeah, you're right.
That's
right.
I'm set. I'm set.
Okay. You were right. I'm wrong. I still do that.
You never do it with me. You never tell me you're wrong.
I got some guys in a truck. I'm always yelling.
From the 49. They fake the end around, a slow developing play, and then a little lob out there to Keely King on the run.
Well, that's what we told to go out, Keely King.
He says, you want me to go out, I'll go out.
Right.
And King takes it way down for a first down.
Keely King, again, 3 years at Army, got that Armed Services Network going again.
Yep.
Army tight end one, now the Beaver coming in. And again, Sarkisian. So elusive in the pocket, doesn't panic when things don't look right, dodges Lorenzo West, moves up in the pocket and finds the fullback in the middle of the field. When you can refocus like that, and that's really the challenge when you're a scrambling type quarterback, is to refocus after you dodge a guy, and he did it well.
Kidd and Manning, the wideouts for Sarkisian, with a first down just outside the south 20.
Ready, hit.
And Emerson again, oh, he's quick in the hole.
This guy's getting drafted. I mean, they're got over a little bit of the jitters early in this football game, a little stage fright playing with the big guys, but he's ready now.
They've had to steer him a couple times today on which direction to go, but he knows where the end zone is,
yeah,
I'll tell you that
thing.
Much.
And up front again, Pat Onofa, number 66, again handled his man, playing center and guard, did a good job. And I tell you, one guy on that offensive line that has played all game and played well is Pat Onofa.
335-pound offensive line.
I guess Troy Davis didn't do it all on his own, huh?
No, he didn't. Loss on that play. Lewis Adams makes a nice play, the linebacker out of Oklahoma State. All the folks that are always so helpful to us when we're out here in Honolulu for the Hula Bowl, and we want to send out some warm wishes to Lenny Klompas, who's the chief executive officer of the Hula Bowl. We understand his mom, Rosalie, is, I think, in the hospital back in Maryland, and we want to wish her the best. She's watching the game back on the East Coast. Your son does a wonderful job out here, and we hope you're feeling better.
This is by far the best Hula Bowl I've attended, and the talent is the best talent they've had out here, and I think this bowl game is on its way back to be what it once was when bowl games were very important. The game, college football, has changed. The combine is such an important thing for these players that the players have adjusted to point towards the combine, but I think this bowl game, when you got an opportunity to come out here, this is the best one I've attended.
And the fans have enjoyed it at the stadium today under 77 degree temps, partly cloudy skies, another beautiful day in paradise.
have a lot of football players in this game that will be drafted in the NFL and will play.
At the 10-yard line.
Let's see if Archie goes left this time. It's the same play.
Yeah, he's going left, but so Sarkisian running for his life. Two and a company run him out of bounds.
Yeah, that time, the problem is that play was read right from the get-go by Lewis Adams, the outside linebacker, number two, and there was nobody to throw to.
Slant corner.
Okay, steady. Okay, slant corner.
Hey, sometimes when your quarterback makes a suggestion, it's worth taking a shot at.
Come here. Get in here.
I think we should run slant corner, Gary.
Slant corner, not a slant fade, okay?
They've been throwing the quick right, slant. This time he wants to fake the slant route and throw it into the end zone.
Just straight up the seam.
Kidd and Manning, the wideouts.
And Leshinsky asked him what did he want him to do. So he goes straight up the seam, right up for the goalpost.
There's the pump fake. There's the corner part. There's the touchdown.
Hey, Lou, maybe the wrong guy was calling plays.
Two.
Let's go for two. 17-yard touchdown, Steve Sarkisian to Brian Manning.
No, this is just the way the play was said, slant corner, and that's as descriptive as it can be, right to the outside, come in on the slant, Brian Manning go to the corner, you get one guy to take a fight in that time, put it to the outside, and that's great.
Brian was the MVP of the West team in the Shrine game. He's played Shrine game last weekend. And has a touchdown here in Hawaii. With 5:13 left to go for two. Kaipo McGuire and James Kidd, the wideouts.
Maybe we'll see that outside kick after this play.
Could be, and I bet you he kicks it to the right deep. Asian. Heavy pressure, down he goes. Holmes is there. So is 2-A. 2-A with a big sack, a big hit on Sarkisian, like Steve needed that one with 5:13 left to go. 26-13. Gary, where should we place this onside
kick?
Here's
where the ball should be kicked this time. Over here is where he wants it. He wants to lob to that side. Not over here where all these guys are. He wants to just lob it over these heads. Let's see after the second try if they get this thing right.
See if Sean readjusts first. He's going to put it up on a tee here in a second. First, we got to have the ready for play whistle. There it is.
Another home. Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Now,
Muhammad's already hip to this. He's dropping back.
Yeah,
and he might be able to shag this thing, too.
Look at this thing. Oh,
little
too
deep.
He kicked that a long way with one step, didn't he?
Yeah, he sure did.
Now, one more coaching point. Don't kick it so hard.
Now, I don't even walk back over there now.
Get a turnover.
Chris Fowler's got it all figured out down there, I think.
We got 2,500 miles to see a clinic on creative onside kicks. Sparked the rally for the North. Archie Amerson won the Walter Payton Award, only the third 2,000-yard rusher in 1AA history. You said you had fun seeing these guys you watched on TV your whole career.
Yeah, you know, ever since I've been in college, I've been watching everybody here, Notre Dame, Florida State. So, you know, it's fun to come out here and compete with these guys.
Now the serious business. You've been kind of overlooked ever since you came out of high school because of your size. Can you prove people wrong one more time and make it in this league?
Oh, yeah. You know, it happened in high school. Then I went to junior college. It happened in junior college. I went to college. And so, you know, every level I go up, they always say I can't do it, but I end up doing it. So, you know, it just makes me play harder.
What's your met the scouts watching this game here and the folks watching back at home?
Oh, just give me a chance, and I'll prove it that I can do it again.
To overcome the nerves. Was it a little nerve-wracking stepping on the field with these guys at first?
No, it was, like, real relaxing. Because we're in Hawaii, so, you know, you can't be uptight over here.
I don't think these quarterbacks would mind. Seems to just give them the ball every play from here on out, guys.
Archie with over 3,100 yards in just two seasons, only the second back in Big Sky history to accomplish a 3,000-yard campaign in just 2 years.
45 ISO, one-on-one, right?
Otten, the quarterback, making the call. Got Ferguson and Sean Mitchell and Emory Smith behind.
Bo Morgan is playing strong safety right now, too.
Well, Bo playing both ways. Rosga is going to make the tackle at the end of the play, also in Tiger Bussey's jersey, as we wind down near the four-minute mark. Those DBs have played the whole way, haven't they?
There you go. They really have. Well, no, actually, towards the end here, as the game has gotten out of whack, they've been substituting in at the strong safety spot. Rosga has been moving side to side. I think even Van Washington has moved in there a couple times to play in the outside to give Herring and Gordon a break. So they found somebody, and also Nate Hemsley, the outside backer, has played some in the backfield. I don't know how good they are back there, but they've lined up.
Under 4 minutes left in a 26-13 South advantage. Smith stood up. Bo Morgan's in on the tackle. So Bo has done a little bit of everything on the field today. Shagging kicks, catching passes, throwing passes, and now making tackles. Just a sensational performer to watch play college football.
Bo Morgan says, hey, I'll try it on this side.
What the heck? 10th in the Heisman balloting this year. Rushed for over 3,000, passed for over 3,000, and accounted for 67 touchdowns in his career. Second down. Long seven. Emory Smith's got the seven, and then he's got a bunch of other yards as he carries people with him. Hemsley and Washington holding on as we go down and check in with Chris again.
Well, guys, here's the linebacker from Navy and the scaler of hotel rooms. Clint Bruce, your right eye's not looking too good, man. What happened?
A communist tried to poke out.
Plotting revenge?
Yeah, I'm going to bite his finger off and send it up to his mother. But no, I hope he didn't mean to. I'm going to ask him in a minute, and if he did, then...
Then we got trouble here?
I have to get him back. It's code of the
Let hill. Us know. We'll keep our cameras around. Hey, listen, you were a late invite to the combine. You have a late chance now to show what you can do. What can you do?
Well, my best. Well, you know, I've got a little easy feeling about this just because... You know, the good Lord's going to put me where he wants me to be. He's 23 years. He's taking me where he wants me. So my job is simply to do my best at whatever they ask me to do. And God will be on Sundays, and well, I'll be playing on Sundays. So.
Well, I know the Lord's on your side if he's letting you scale balconies 17 stories up there, my friend. Get a key next time, huh?
I was talking to him for the most of it. Going, all right. Thanks, God. Here we go.
Clint Bruce has made quite an impression out here, guys.
Wow, our shores are safe, I think.
I hope that guy didn't poke him in the eye. That's all
I do too.
Say.
Her mom's getting a gift in the mail. And it's not a postcard of Waikiki Beach.
Just
oh, what
luck.
A beauty he is.
He just might like to pick a fight with a Navy SEAL.
Yeah, that'd be bad. New Staley covered up the ball with both hands, gets it to the 45-yard line. And Danny Werfel, a Heisman Trophy winner, signing some souvenirs. That's the most his right arm was put to use today due to the shoulder injury. But he'll be back. It'll be interesting to see. Not highly rated by professional scouts. But the guy has always won and won a ton of games and gotten it done with his arms. It's going to be interesting to see how his...
Steve Spurrier says he can play. I think he can play.
Probably.
Thank you. Right here on the corner.
So I said to Henny, of course, chickens are more important to Hooters than owls.
Who?
Chickens, that's who's that?
I beg to differ.
Well, beg all you want. Without chickens, there'd be no chicken sandwiches or chicken salads. Or Hooters' famous chicken wings. There'd be no Hooters if it weren't for chicken.
It's really not wise to even argue the point.
That's because I'm wrong.
No, that's because you're not going to be around long anyway. Chicken.
Ooh, this looks like a good spot.
Telling you, no such thing as UFOs.
Come on, we might see one.
Ah, aliens!
Very funny.
UFOs. Ah! What? What is it?
Oh, my gosh.
Don't move. Ooh, where would I go? Honey, where's the Ericsson cellular phone?
Here, call.
Hello?
Ericsson cellular phones when life gets a little wild.
Honey, they want to know where we're calling from.
You want a highly reliable Ericsson cellular phone.
There's a medical emergency, but no hospital. What do you do? Build one. Leadership. Learn it now in the Army Reserve. Use it now in your career.
McDonald's not-so-risky predictions for 1997. At some point, you'll be put on hold. At some point, you'll crave an Arch Deluxe. Fresh toppings, a soft bakery roll, and no waiting for the next available operator. McDonald's Arch Deluxe, America's favorite grown-up taste.
Out of the final 138 of the 51st edition of the Hula Bowl. And the South on its way to a win. Steve Sarkisian and Akili King having a moment on the sideline. But today, just not enough protection from the offensive line of the North that was depleted by injuries. And probably was the difference in the ball game, or the difference in it being much closer. Otten is going to give it to Sean Mitchell. And Sean goes down to the 40-yard line, and that's first down. Our Hooters players of the game. Archie Amerson, who says he's looking forward to the next level. Somebody give me a chance. So they gave him five chances today. One of them went for a very quick touchdown. He wins it for the North. For the South, Andy Russ.
The punter.
How about this guy? The punter and place kicker who hit four field goals and his extra points and also doubled as the punter. And so he goes from a non-illustrious kicking career at Mississippi State, where he told us he never hit a field goal, to hit four of them today in the Hula Bowl. And he also had four punts.
Oh,
well,
fumble.
And loose ball.
North has the football.
Yeah, they're going to have another shot here with 1:05 left.
Is this game choreographed, or is there's a minute and one to go. Oh,
that might be. It might be too early, Coach.
You expect that?
No, not an all-star game. It's illegal in an all-star game, I thought.
Would have felt better in New Orleans, I know.
Yeah, it would have felt
congratulations.
Better.
A little bit of revenge for that Peach Bowl you talked about at halftime when Lou beat you.
Yeah. I tell you, they made a great comeback, but again, if we can stop them here, it's still, what, a 104 up there?
Well, you're not counting the win yet?
Not yet,
premature
buddy.
Gatorade. You went through that in the Orange Bowl a couple years ago in Nebraska.
I don't need two Gatorades either. One was enough. I thought they were setting me up for something. Too many kids.
Well, we better get off the field here. Enjoy your offseason, Coach.
I thought there was for sure going to be a gosh dummit in there on that exchange between those two. Sarkisian has to get around 2-and-A again. Throws on the run. And the tight end, Leshinsky, takes it right through the ice where they just dumped Coach Bowden. He has to run right through that ice mess at the 50-yard line. So clock stop with 55 seconds left.
We can't get beat.
See, it's dangerous. Need a Zamboni or something out here.
You might need to run a route right through there.
Yeah. You get your defensive back turned around, and you just take it up the sideline.
Tailback. Let's go left weak. Tailback flag X. On set. Ready?
Going to get it in the hands of Amerson again?
I think they are. Going to try to run them deep this time.
If he has time to throw, steps up in the pocket. Scrambles around, comes back to the tight end right in that same pile of ice. And Leshinsky, I thought he went out of bounds. I guess
well, everybody else did too, except the official calling it.
And so he takes it down the sideline to the 32-yard line. Clint Bruce knocks him out of bounds. So Navy knocks out Army. And we continue our military theme from Honolulu. 43 seconds left. Sarkisian, 28 passes today, has completed 18.
I think Sarkisian has played wonderfully in this football game, to tell you the truth. He has been under pressure all game, and he has kept his eyes downfield. He's not give up on it, and he's still throwing the ball accurately.
Poised in the pocket.
Yes.
And there's Steve's numbers today. Sets up and going long. Laying it out there for Manning, and it's out of bounds. And it almost took one of our security people out of bounds with him.
And he kept that ball in the playing field, Sarkisian, that time. I think Manning would have beaten Anthony Fogel because Fogel got turned around that time and never saw the football.
We've done games where Steve Sarkisian has thrown 50 passes, and then we did one that we kidded around with him a little bit yesterday at practice about. He said, yeah, you did us once this year. We threw 12 passes, but they ran for about 400 yards against Utah. Remember
they had,
that one?
They had five quarterbacks cancel their visit.
I don't think Lavelle's ever going to quit throwing it, but he did that day. From the shotgun. Down the middle, man open. It's Kaipo McGuire. From Pearl City, Hawaii.
Hey, down it! Down it!
And now they're going to have to hurry up.
Down it! I'm set!
To come up to the ball.
Of course, the clock is stopped till they get the thing set.
They just don't want to waste any more time. That's heads up. Just get it stopped right there, then regroup from the 15-yard line.
Especially because probably half the offensive linemen aren't breathing right now.
It's always good to just get your win before the next snap.
Archie out. Hey, split right.
Going to try that one more time to get it in Amerson's hands, huh?
Wide out and up on this, okay? Yeah, we're going to go slant deep. Here we go. Split right, quick slant deep. On set. Ready?
He's going to try to bring Archie and run a flat and up to the outside. Archie's going to come out here and then go up the sideline, bringing the receiver to the inside.
There it is, the pump fake, and now the sideline, and he didn't get enough on it. Amerson was open at the five, but that's a kind of a long throw when you're backpedaling.
Skinny post.
Jimmy Post.
Now we're down to the post coming up with 20 seconds remaining.
Archie was kind of happy that one was thrown a little short because Ricky Parker had him labeled.
Sights, yeah. Had the crosshairs on him.
Go. Split right gun, skinny post. Onset, onset. Ready?
Work from the gun, give himself maybe a little more time to look things over on a third down and 10.
See if he might look for a Marcus Harris on this one, big wide receiver.
That's who he's looking for.
Oh, interference there, huh?
There's a flag. It came in late, finally, on Fogle, who bumped Harris at the goal line. So right down to the final 16 seconds, Frank White is.
Are we going to get a chance to see one more? I wanted to see one more onside kick. I really do. See if we can get that thing right.
We're running out of time.
Defensive pass interference.
If they could score, I think we're going to get one more. And we're set an NCAA record for onside kicks in the game.
First down.
We would have our fifth onside kick of the game?
That's right.
That would set a record.
From Kona, the senior PGA Golf MasterCard Championship is coming up following our football game.
Left. Quick slant.
Which has somewhere around 16 seconds left.
Yeah, yeah.
Kidd and Manning, the wideouts. Amberson, the tailback. Sarkisian looks right, the slant, and overshot Manning.
Manning got inside that time. Threw it a little high.
Come on, baby.
Down to 13 seconds and second and goal.
Right. Let's go. Hey, get a push right now. Get a push. Let's go. Right, iso right. I'm one on. Ready? I'm one.
I think the I formation here is going to mean they're going to run an isolation play.
Ready, hit.
Here it comes. Amberson hitting the backfield, bounces off, and he's not getting
it. I think our Navy SEAL that time just put his helmet in the backfield.
Everybody Clint, around the ball.
Clint Bruce just met that isolation back just after Amberson got the ball. Bruce. Ran right over Schuster.
Bruce and then Adams and Spain joined the group.
I think Schuster, he thought Schuster had his key.
I was out on my balcony 17 stories up. You took my key.
Here he comes.
Here's payback.
Whoa. Stop right here.
Nice collision with Schuster, and then Adams gets there. So does Spain and Ray Austin to clean up. That's your isolation. That nice meeting between fullback and middle linebacker that happens so often in games. So now we're down to one play. I don't think we're going to get a chance for another onside kick.
Yeah, too bad.
Unless we get a really quick touchdown here.
Bruce is playing with one eye, but he could hit an isolation play with no eyes. I've probably seen so many of them.
He dropped off and then threw it to you.
Coach Bowden's got the shades flipped up. I think he thinks he's safe now. 26-13.
It's like Red Auerbach's cigar.
Yep. Could be the final play of the game, unless they get a very quick one. Here's the fade for Harris. Well, he got his hands on it, which was a pretty nice job.
And that's it.
That is going to do it. Fogle was defending. And the 51st edition of the Hula Bowl is history. Good job it was. Big lead early by the South. North battled back. Steve Sarkisian never quit. But in the end, South had a little bit too much firepower, and the North a little bit too short on its offensive line as far as healthy bodies. And Bobby Bowden, his club defeats Lou Holtz's team. 26-13 is the final.
You okay?
And at that point, that's what you're hoping, that everybody's okay and nobody comes out of it injured.
There is someone down in the field. I can't see who it is, but there is someone down.
Hey, you guys did a nice job, man.
Yeah. And that would be an all-time problem.
Is it an offa? It's either Anafa or Cone. It's one of the Iowa State offensive linemen, that's for sure.
And Mike McNeil, Vice President of Lou.
Well, a ball game that saw Brad Otten hook up with Chris
comeback.
Miller early.
Great comeback.
Some good kicking.
You couldn't get you
two old friends.
The second half, then you got good rhythm.
We could protect the pass.
And there's one of the touchdowns that helped get him the big halftime lead. Don't forget, senior PGA is coming up next. For Gary Danielson and Chris Fowler, mahalo from Aloha Stadium. I'm Brad Nessler. Thanks for joining us for the Hula Bowl.